be a long day for the Beavers.
Yeah, Derek Anderson, once he got to Pac-10 play, nine touchdowns, 11 picks. He struggled.
So, that game is coming up. Steven Jackson and company, Pittsburgh and Oregon State.
Take you to Phoenix as bowl week continues. We'll have a lot more at halftime after this.
This is the sound. These are the results. This is the sound of the Power Flex by Gold's Gym, the authority since 1965. Gold's Gym gives you one powerful machine with 65 club-quality exercises. The secret to the Power Flex begins with the swivel flex pulleys that provide you with free range of motion. Next, Power Stroke Resistance simulates the natural movement of your muscles and allows you to move from 10 to 410 pounds of resistance with one simple stroke. Call now for free information about how you can get the Gold's Gym Power Flex in your home for as little as $49 a month. With the Gold's Gym Power Flex, you get the lat tower, the multi-position bench, hip strap, rowing seat, ankle strap, handles, and face saver design. Be one of the first callers, and you'll get the Gold's Gym Power Flex Leg Developer for stronger legs and shapelier hips and thighs. A $200 value, absolutely free. Call the number on your screen now.
Bowl Week, where history is made and legends live on.
Showdown time for Ron Day.
And here goes the big fella. Day cuts back, and now he's going to take it. The Madison Express touchdown. Breeze lobs it for the end zone. Got him there. Touchdown, Isaac Jones. Will Breeze stuck it right in there. This one is over.
Tonight in Phoenix, we'll see the Big East leading receiver, just a true freshman, Larry Fitzgerald. And on the Oregon State side, we will see the leading rusher in the Pac-10, just a sophomore, fifth in the country this year. The Bob Bank One ballpark expected to be full. Better than 40,000 tonight for this first ever matchup in the Inside Bowl between number 23 Pittsburgh and Oregon State. We've shown you Larry Fitzgerald. Let's hear from him now. He is down below for a chat with Dave Ryan.
What is it about your demeanor that's able to handle a pressure so well?
I look at it, in the NFL, I see guys' careers are very short, so I just try to come out here every day and try to get better, because I know, never know when your last play is going to be, so I just try to come out and execute the offense and do what the coach asked me to do, and do the little things that, other guys won't do, because I know how short somebody's career could be.
You may match up with Dennis Weathersby of Oregon State as their cornerback, who said it's a test to his manhood if he can stop you. Is that a big challenge? Can you respond to that?
No, I try not to make personal challenges out there on the football field. This is a team game. We got to come out here and win as a team. We got to run the ball. We got to be able to pass the ball. So, you can't look at it one-on-one, all that stuff. It's not basketball. You got to play as a team game. You got to come out here and do the little things to win the game. It's not going to be Larry Fitzgerald and Dennis Weathersby.
Thanks a lot for your time.
No, thank you.
Larry Fitzgerald, more than five catches a game. Dave Barnett, number one in the Big East Conference this year.
And he's put on a great show all season long. We expect nothing different tonight. Welcome to Phoenix, Bank One Ballpark, usually the home of the Diamondbacks. It looks all right for football tonight. Dave Barnett, Phil Curry, and Mike Golick. Oregon State started well, 4-0, then they hit a ditch. They lost three straight, and they got out of that ditch and made it here because they made a decision to give Steven Jackson the ball 25, 30, 35 times a game, whatever it took.
They made it, or maybe Steven made it. Leaders surface when you're in trouble. Steven Jackson went to the coaches and said, give me the football. I don't care how many times you get. I will carry this team on my back. The result, 1,656 yards and 15 touchdowns, number one in the Pac-10 as a rusher. On the other side of the ball, an outstanding middle linebacker in Gerald Hayes. His defensive linemen must penetrate. This is Paul Rhodes, the defensive coordinator's plan tonight. They've got to penetrate. The linemen have got to take up more than one blocker so that Gerald Hayes can stay clean to tackle Steven Jackson, and that'll be a heck of a matchup.
Mike, Pittsburgh is not real happy about how they came in here. They lost their last two, both by just seven, one to number one Miami, one to their rival West Virginia. But all season long, the progression of Larry Fitzgerald has been incredible to watch.
This is a man well beyond his 19 years. He plays so much more mature than that. Where do you see this kid go up for the ball? He just goes up and takes it away from those defenders. And I know we talked to Dave Ryan and said it's not about matchups. Well, sorry, Larry. It's going to be about a matchup tonight with you and Dennis Weathersby. He matches up decently in the height at 6'1". Weathersby loves to get on the line of scrimmage and loves to jam the receiver. So this will be an individual matchup that may have a big outcome on the game. So Larry may not care much about it, Dave, but we're going to keep an eye on it.
Dennis Erickson, in his fourth year as the head coach at Oregon State, has them in the third bowl in those 4 years. They had been to three in their previous 43 years. And Walt Harris has taken the Panthers back to the postseason, his sixth year. Last year they won the Tangerine. They're in their fourth bowl in his 6 years, and they're happy that he has stuck around that long. He's a name that's been thrown into a lot of different coaching opening scenarios. He says no truth to any of it. Happy where I am. He's happy to have Larry Fitzgerald, one of the best true freshmen you'll ever see, ready to go back to work tonight as the Panthers and Beavers meet for the first time ever. Oregon State has won the toss and deferred. Torrey Cox and Shante Spencer are back deep for the Panthers, and Ryan Sefka is set to kick it off for Oregon State. Both 8-4 for the Beavers. A ninth win would equal their second best season ever. 2 years ago, of course, they finished number four in the country, 11-1. Won the Fiesta Bowl over Notre Dame just down the road in Tempe. A new field laid down over the baseball field here. The roof is open. We're underway in the inside bowl. Cox from a yard deep. Bounces off a tackle. Turns it into a nice return and finally driven out at the 31-yard line. 32 on the return, and junior Rod Rutherford from Pittsburgh, a 31% passer his first 2 years. Walt Harris says something happened to him over the summer, and he has been a completely different quarterback this year. Second team all Big East. The Coors Light offensive lineup for the Panthers.
I think number 83, the tight end Chris Wilson, is a potentially great player. Averages 22.5 yards per catch catching the football.
There's Wilson, flexed out, has a slot left, and an empty backfield. They screen five receivers across the line for Rutherford. And he finds Wilson for a gain of about 6 yards. Richard Siegler, the middle linebacker, with the first of probably many tackles for him tonight. For the Panther offensive line, they are nothing if not experienced, and experienced together. They've been together as a group for the better part of the last 2 years. And they're led by Anderson, a four-year starter, his 47th start tonight, his 34th in a row. Up front, Swancutt leads that group with 10 sacks. Manning, for the second time this year, named first team all Pac-10. Again, the empty backfield. And the short drop by Rutherford, dangerous runner. And room up the middle for the first down to the 47-yard line. Nick Barnett and Eric Tuma, linebackers on either side of Siegler, with that tackle. And Barnett also first team all Pac-10. He led the conference this year, 112 tackles in the regular season.
And we talked about Weathersby in the open, the cornerback, both these corners. He and Roberts love to play man. They'll get up on the line and jam. But interesting first two plays for Pittsburgh. All wide receivers, no running backs, because Oregon State will not put a nickel in. They'll keep those three linebackers in.
Offset eye this time. Fitzgerald went in motion. And the first give to Brandon Myrie, the transfer from Alabama. Won the starting tailback job midseason. And Mitch Musin, the free safety, brings down Brandon Myrie. 110 yards per game in the last four. That included his big breakout, 161, and the game-winning touchdown at then-undefeated number three, Virginia Tech.
Now we did that game, and we saw how that offensive line and Myrie just pounded Virginia Tech at that point, which was number one in the country, giving up just 40 yards on the ground as the team Pittsburgh rushed for 275 yards in that one.
Myrie alone behind Rutherford on second down and three. And And Rutherford gets that one complete to Lamar Slade, who shoved out at the 36, another Panther first down. 10 yards, Slade number 5 receiver in the Big East, 45 catches and 4 for touchdowns this year.
This is a really interesting start. Slade exploding off the ball against the man coverage, and he simply stops, and the ball is lofted out. He fakes a burst down the field and just comes back to the soft throw. Weathersby should be a little off balance, having to deal with something unusual right off the bat.
Overshadowed by Fitzgerald, Slade, a senior, brother of Chris Slade, longtime NFL linebacker out of Yorktown, Virginia. And that one dropped by Fitzgerald. It was close to being a backward pass, but it is incomplete, and there's a marker down.
I do not believe my eyes, Mike. I do not believe it.
He can't be doing that, and penalty going to be against Pittsburgh. We just talked him up. He can't be dropping that. I don't think he'll do that much tonight, but very interesting start for Pittsburgh. We saw the 5 wide receiver set, 4 wide receiver set again. Do we hear the call?
Illegal formation. Offense, 5 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
Oregon State will not bring in a nickel. They will not bring in an extra defensive back as we see the drop by Fitzgerald. They think their linebackers can cover just as good as any nickel back that could come in, so that's why Pittsburgh started out with more wide receivers trying to take an early advantage of it.
Big Ten officiating crew headed by David Woodbow backs them up 5, so first and 15. And the toss right from Irie. Looks for a cutback alley, not much of one, only a yard. Juan Edwards, junior defensive tackle, making the stop for Oregon State. The number 10 defense in the country and number 9 against the rush, just 92 yards per game they have surrendered on the ground this year.
Yeah, this is a team, guys, that I don't think a lot of people know about. We talked about Steven Jackson at the top. You did, Bill, but this offensively and defensively, these are two terrific teams.
10th and 11th in America defending.
Fitzgerald from the slot back in motion. And the blitz of Rutherford picked up nicely. Has time to fire one deep. Fitzgerald open. A diving catch for a touchdown.
Are you kidding me?
There he is, folks. That's the guy.
That is a true freshman.
What they did is they isolated him on the free safety, Mitch Mewson, who simply cannot run with him. Number 5, Mewson, in futile pursuit. Look at this, folks. Oh. That is a fantastic football catch. That's Jerry Rice reincarnated.
I guess he made it for the drop, huh, guys?
Wow.
What drop?
Yeah, exactly. David Abdul, another talented true freshman, adds the extra point just like that. 7-0 Pittsburgh. Walt Harris told us midseason, and his offensive coordinator J.D. Brookhart agree. They said they have never seen a receiver anywhere with hands, with ball skills like Larry Fitzgerald. That's what they were talking about.
This is Gladys. Gladys works for a big computer reseller. When she's done selling, this is what you're left with. Jennifer works at Insight. She helps you find the products you need at prices you like from an inventory of over 100,000 products. Experts like Jack, Ann, and Jim design, configure, and deliver even the most complex IT solutions. From a single notebook to enterprise networks, Insight delivers more products, expertise, and value, even financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
I have an idea. There, honey. Feel safe?
Now the monsters are under the caravan.
No, they aren't. I'll show you.
Dodge Caravan. A feeling of security no matter what lies ahead.
Told you so.
Sure. Let's hide under the minivan. Great idea.
Sea Monsters, Inc. Now on DVD and in the Dodge Caravan.
Grab
that is 770 powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it.
It's the most wonderful week of the year.
Friday, Jamal Lord and Nebraska's high-speed ground game square off against Eli Manning and the Ole Miss air attack. And later, L. Roberson leads K-State's powerhouse offense against Sackmaster Terrell Suggs and the Sun Devils. Nebraska, Mississippi in the Mainstay Independence Bowl at 4:30. Kansas State, Arizona State in the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl at 8. Capital One Bowl Week continues Friday on ESPN.
Larry Fitzgerald not only led the Big East in catches, but also with 11 touchdowns. Here's his 12.
It was a blitz that was picked up very well. You see the inside route by Slade, outside route by Fitzgerald, just runs by Mewson. I mean, what an absolute mismatch there. Swancutt gets a little bit of pressure on him at the end, but Barnett was a linebacker that blitzed. He was picked up. And Rutherford says, oh, yeah, let me throw it to my guy.
Rutherford just throws it as far as he can. Because my guy can lay out and fly, whether he runs particularly fast or not, and he does have good speed, not great speed, but there are very few people, folks, that can lay out, catch that football, and maintain it.
Panther kickoff, David Abdul. Sending this one down to the 2-yard line. And Brandon Kennedy's return back to the 28. And then fumbled after he was down. Oregon State will start from there. Oregon State, in their 4-0 start, featured terrific play from their sophomore quarterback, Derek Anderson. He averaged 300 yards passing, threw 15 touchdowns, 60%. Then problems. 0-for-3, he got beat up. And they relied heavily on Steven Jackson from that point on, as you see the Coors Light backs and receivers.
And we've been talking about Larry Fitzgerald for Pittsburgh. How about James Newsom for Oregon State? Over 1,000 yards receiving, and receiving yards, 64 receptions, 11 touchdowns as well.
And a typical Dennis Erickson one-back set. Play action, first catch of the day, James Newsom, who should have a first down. 65th catch of the year in Oregon State record. Torrey Cox makes the stop. The offensive line features three sophomores who helped the Beavers lead the Pac-10 in rushing at 160 yards per game. Brock, the leader of the group, out of Roseburg, the 300-pound center. And Harriet, first-team All-Big East defensive end with 7.5 sacks. Krochunas, Stevens, and Guzik, the rest of the Panther front four. Any Dennis Erickson offense, going back as far as you can remember, features the one back, the three receivers, and incredible speed. And he says this, Bill, is his fastest team ever. Think about that.
That is scary if you have to compete against him, because I saw some of his Miami team, and they could fly.
It was enough for the first. Well, from 38, they send Cole Clayton in motion. And Jackson gets his first carry. He will lose 3 yards. Panthers are ready to jump on him, led by Dan Stevens.
But Gerald Hayes and company, and he has a fine company in Beinecke and Moore, an excellent linebacking crew. What they need is the kind of penetration that we just saw in the previous play by the big guys up front.
Cox, unanimous first-team All-Big East corner. Ian Robinson, seniors, playing their final game in the Panther secondary. Fourth leading tackler in Pittsburgh history, 3 times All-Big East. And the Big East Defensive Player of the Year, a second-team All-American. Plenty of time for Anderson to eat. Deep caught again at midfield. Newsom, was he not down? He must not have been, and Newsom takes it all the way. Touchdown, 65 yards. How in the world did he stay up at midfield?
Torrey Cox and Brian Beneke ran into each other. Well, like I said, we talked about the shell on one side. Newsom is the man on the other. How did he come out of that one? Cox gets turned around. There's the collision.
Wow.
Oh, he stayed up. Great call by the official.
That was incredible that they got that right, because it would have been a shame to deny him that touchdown after the balance and the athletic move he made.
Kirk Ilanimi ties it.
Well, where do we go from here?
We've got some football, some real football here.
Go get all the chips and dip now and don't leave the couch. Cox and Banky going to hit each other there. Oh, incredible. He falls on his forearm and stays up.
Does the elbow touch?
Oh, yeah, the elbow's down, but the knee's not down. Incredible job.
You said incredible job.
Unbelievable and incredible. I put them together. How's that? That's how amazing it was.
A couple inches of daylight between knee and grass.
What that is balance, but it's also sheer physical strength. When Coach Erickson talked about Newsom, he talked about the fact this guy is powerful. He's all man. He's got the same number of catches as our man Fitzgerald on the other side of the ball. He's got more yards, same number of touchdowns, and he's just matched him so to keep it even here in this game.
And we'll keep an eye. Brian Beinecke went off limping when he and Torrey Cox ran into one another. Keep an eye on that injury, but boy, oh boy.
That was incredible. You got it right.
Well, there you have it. I'm making up new words.
A combination of unbelievable and incredible.
Just call
I like
me.
It.
Call me Don King. I'll just make it all up.
No, I don't think we're gonna have to do something with your hair before we can do that.
Boy, you're right, Dave. Where do we go from here? Oh,
James Newsom breaking his own Oregon State record with his 12th touchdown of the year. That's his kick coming down to Shante Spencer. And the return of 11 yards. Well, Fitzgerald threw the opening punch and Newsom countered.
They set the bar kind of high, haven't they? A flag down again.
We're about to put it down.
You know, Newsom listened to all the talk, read all the stories about the incredible freshman, the uncredible freshman, and knew he had a little something of his own to unveil. And not many people east of Oregon have seen.
Personal foul on the kicking team. 15 yards from the end of the run.
Now, here we go. Oregon State has over 100 yards a game in penalties. This is a characteristic of Dennis Erickson's teams, and he will put up with a lot of aggressiveness. He doesn't like the cheap shots and that sort of thing, but they will take their hits, and they're going to be right on the edge as a defensive unit. They've given up 45 first downs by penalty this season.
That is 11 more than any other team in the country gave up. And squeezing through is Myrie for a couple. Well, Friday, Capital One Bowl Week continues here on ESPN with a triple hitter. Our day begins with College Game Day Bowl Special. It's presented by Outback at Noon Eastern. Then at 1 Eastern, Southern Miss, Oklahoma State, Reliance Stadium, the new site for the 2002 Houston Bowl. 4:30 Eastern, Eli Manning at Ole Miss against Nebraska in the Mainstay Independence Bowl. 8 Eastern, Kansas State, Arizona State in the Pacific Light Holiday Bowl. Rutherford out of the gun with a fake to Myrie. And a quarterback draw, which feels no one. Certainly didn't fool Eric Manning. Let's send it down below to the fourth member of our crew, Dave Ryan.
Well, Dave, the feel-out process going on with both sides. Each team seemed a bit tentative emotionally. That's until the big play was made by Larry Fitzgerald. Keep in mind, only 1,000 fans are here from Pittsburgh, so they didn't have a big emotional presence with their fans. He got the bench going. When they saw the play on the replay, they exploded. James Newsom, the same thing for Oregon State. Many more Oregon State fans are here, guys. They've got the momentum with the crowd right now.
And they hope their defense can shut down the 3rd and 8. Rutherford again protected very well, but he underthrows Slade. And Slade was open a couple of steps in front of Houston.
And we just watched the number one defense in America against third down conversions. Less than 25%, 24.7% first downs allowed by Oregon State when the other team's trying to make a first down on third down. That is downright incredible as a statistic.
Oh, I tell you, I'm never going to live it down.
No. All right. Word of the night.
Yep.
Andy Lee led the Big East better than 43 yards per kick. Gets off a big one, backing up down to the 8-yard line, Eric Williams. And Williams returns to the 26 and stuck there by Lewis Moore. 54 yards on the first punt of the night by Lee. Steven Jackson, number five in the country, number one in the Pac-10. Back to work in a 7-7 game in Phoenix. The Inside Bowl.
This is how most computer products arrive at your business. And this is what's left after the box is unpacked. At Insight, account executives help you find the products you need at the best prices. Hundreds of certified technicians and engineers design, configure, test, and install your IT equipment. Whether you're buying for a home office or one of the Fortune 1000, you get the best combination of product, expertise, and price. Right down to financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
Introducing the new 215 horsepower Chrysler PT Turbo.
You really think Bionic Woman would beat the $6 million man in a foot race?
She's smaller, so she's more aerodynamic.
With a Getrag manual transmission.
He was 6 mil. Now, what was she? 3, 4.5 tops?
It was a TV show,
they're
not real.
What if they had a kid? That'd be one bad kid.
PT Turbo. It'll really have you thinking fast. Now, for a limited time, choose one of three $500 Sony personal entertainment packages when you buy any new PT Cruiser.
I love football on TV. Shots of Gina Lee. Hanging with my friends and twins. I love burritos at 4 a.m., parties that never end, dogs that love cats, and twins, and I love you too. It's a love song.
One ballpark on a cool night, maybe headed down to the 40s in Phoenix. And a 7-7 start. 8-10 to play first quarter from the 26. Oregon State will have their second possession. First one ended rather spectacularly on a 65-yard balancing act. Catch and run by James Newsom. Eric Anderson's 25th touchdown pass of the season. Fires that one out complete for a short gain as Cox immediately takes down Newsom. And they've got a word or two. Dave Ryan, what was Torrey Cox's view on that touchdown?
Well, Dave, Torrey Cox, the senior leadership really standing up and taking responsibility for not bringing down James Newsom on that long Oregon State touchdown play a few moments ago. You just mentioned, Cox said, guys, it was my fault. I'm going to stand up and take responsibility, and it will not, I promise, will not happen again. We shall see.
Well, he's usually good for his word. Unanimous first-team all-conference movement from tight end Jermaine Jackson on the right side of the line for Oregon State.
Prior to the snap, ball start, offense, 5 yards, down in the lane, second.
7-7 in the Inside Bowl. In the home of the Diamondbacks, Bank One Ballpark, downtown Phoenix, Dave Barnett, Bill Curry, Mike Golick, and Dave Ryan. We have seen two of the best catches we've seen all year, just about any year. Diving layout, 40 yards by Fitzgerald. And then Newsom somehow manages not to hit the deck after being blasted at midfield, gets up, runs the rest of the way for 65 yards to tie it. So Oregon State, after forcing an Andy Lee punt, has it for the second time, and that one's up for grabs and incomplete, intended for Sean Kittner, who was covered well by Sean Robinson. It'll be third and 11.
What a different way these teams are doing it. You saw Pittsburgh come out with five wide receivers and four wide receivers. Here with Oregon State, it's two wide receivers, two tight ends, and the one back in Jackson always having that threat of the run, using that play action.
Anderson just a 47% passer, and that's after starting the first four games of 60% passer. When he got beat up midseason, his numbers really suffered. They blitz him, and they get him inside the 15. Claude Harriott now with 8.5 sacks to lead the Panthers on the year.
This is a stunt. The defensive staff of Pittsburgh does not feel like that the offensive line has quite the quickness that they're accustomed to seeing, and so they're using stunts, and Harriet got up the middle and got clean and got the first big shot on Anderson.
First punt of the night by Carl Toby is a good one, and it backs Sean Robinson up inside his 30. And a flag down at the end of the return. Two markers down, in fact. After a 55-yard punt by the junior, Toby.
Well, for these two teams never playing before, they sure talk to each other like they've been playing each other a lot. There are a lot of conversations out
Isn't
there.
Isn't that part of the bowl week thing, though, yes. When you're in town long enough to have this type of buildup? And
well, it is, and I remember, as we get the call, I went to Pittsburgh practice on
turn the return. Illegal block in the back above the waist. Unreturning team. 10 yards from the end of the run.
And after the practice, Walt Harris was talking to his team. They were going to a function that night with Oregon State and said, all right, guys, let's be careful what we do out there, and we meet these guys.
Larry Fitzgerald has already done some magic with a diving touchdown catch to give Pittsburgh a lead. Oregon State has answered. Fitzgerald back to work next.
College basketball on ESPN. Take it to the rack with a full day of high-intensity matchup.
Look out!
First, the Bluegrass rivalry heats up again as Pete Bogans leads Kentucky against Rick Pitino's Louisville squad, led by sweet shooting Reed Gaines. Then Bobby Knight is back in the Big Ten as it's Red Raiders and their main man, Andre Emmett, face Minnesota. College hoops all day Saturday on ESPN and ESPN2.
You've spent the entire month making everyone else happy. Now it's payback time. Announcing the AGA It's All About You sale. Take advantage of low sale fares from $55 to $89 to all our continental U.S. destinations and do the things you want to do. Better hurry. This sale ends January 13th. Complete travel by April 30th. Earn free travel with our new Anniversary Travel Awards promotion. Log on to ATA.com for details. ATA, an honestly different airline.
It's the Hyundai Win-Win Year-End Event, where you can save thousands over a comparable Honda or Toyota because you win with cash back on 2002 and 2003 models. Like $1,000 back on a 2003 Hyundai Elantra, and win with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. But this event ends January 5th, so hurry. Win with cash back, win with America's best warranty. With Hyundai, you win.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2002 Insight Bowl, presented by Insight. Only Insight delivers the best combination of computer products, services, and price. Insight, whatever it takes. And in part by Jeep, the most respected, honored, and heroic 4x4s out there. Only in a Jeep 4x4. And by Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light. Cold. Down. Easy.
Panthers on their third possession will start from the 25-yard line. Just under the 7-minute mark, 7-7 game in the first quarter. And the rushing yards have been tough to come by so far for the tailback who transferred from Alabama, Brandon Myrie, won the job from Raymond Kirkland midseason. And they said he was simply the most complete running back they had. He won the job because he outworked the others. He executed the reads the best. He was the most consistent. And he ended the year with 830 yards. And big games, as we said, against Virginia Tech. 118 yards against Miami. Closed with 121 against West Virginia. They lost those last two. Can't pin much on Myrie. Bursting to the secondary and across the 40 with a first down and a gain of 15 yards. He finally has a crack, and Houston and Terrell Roberts bring him down.
Nick Barnett, number 42, a rare missed tackle, a fine linebacker for Oregon State. Excellent blocking here, maybe just a little bit of a grab right there. 77, Brian Anderson, but excellent burst by Myrie, and really the first trace of a running game we've seen tonight because they are outnumbered. Both these defenses are outnumbering the running game. An extra tackle.
Rutherford pointing out some of those potential tacklers before giving to Myrie again. And about 9 yards across midfield with a 48. And again, Houston, the free safety, called on for the tackle.
Excellent job by the Pittsburgh offensive line getting on block. Oregon State defenders not getting off the block. Just staying on their man. They've got to extend with those hands and come off. Myrie into the second level before he's even touched. As Dave mentioned, we weren't sure where this running game was going to go with Pittsburgh. It took off at times.
Gain of 15, followed by a gain of 9. Myrie again runs into his line and then backs up, tries that same hole again, still going down to the 39. If at first you don't succeed,
stay after it, and you'll get your first down.
And another gain of 9.
One of the things that you can't teach a running back, and in fact you wouldn't want to, is a spin move. It's something that happens instinctively. Excellent blocking again, Myrie, good balance, looking for a spot. Now watch when the tackle attempt occurs. Boom, there goes the spin. And he's off that tackler and up the field for another 4 yards. It's a natural thing. He also keeps the ball secured, which is very important if you're going to do that spin.
Rutherford going for Fitzgerald again. Open again. Batted away at the goal line by Weathersby. So Fitzgerald beat Newton. Weathersby, for this play at least, is his equal.
There's matchup number one on the deep ball to Fitzgerald with Weathersby. Again, he's better on the line, jamming. You see Fitzgerald got by him. A little more on the pass. He's got to slow up for it. Good job of jumping at the same time. Maybe got a little grab of the shirt. Hey, you know what? You don't get called. That's a fine move. No problem with that at all. If you can get away with it. But what I like is the way he timed his jump with Fitzgerald. That's what Larry has done so well, is outjumped his opponent. Weathersby jumped right with him.
First time tonight, those two have been matched one-on-one. Out of the gun. And up to the 35 goes Myrie. From there, third and 6.
I'll tell you, Oregon State is very fortunate that Dwan Edwards just made that tackle. That would have been a cut.
You take a look at the two plays that brought the score where it was. A great layout by Larry Fitzgerald. And then Newsom, watch him keep his balance here. He never touches the ground.
And you can see why Torrey Cox took responsibility, because he ducked his head. All he had to do was keep his head up, and he would have come down with the tackle.
They run Fitzgerald in motion. And Rutherford running out of time. And they'll rule him in the grasp and down to midfield. As Nick Barnett, the leading tackler in the Pac-10, comes in for his 6th sack.
You can see how Barnett runs extremely well. He's also the hardest working football player on this team. He'll be coming from his linebacker spot. Now here's where it gets interesting. What does the rule say? He's driving Rutherford backward. As he drives him backward, the whistle blows. So even though Rutherford appeared to escape, the play was over. There's no such thing as in the grass in college football. If your forward progress is stopped long enough in the judgment of the official, then the play is over.
Oregon State calls time, 3:28, first quarter, 7-7.
This is Gladys. Gladys works for a big computer reseller. When she's done selling, this is what you're left with. Jennifer works with Insight. She helps you find the products you need at prices you like from an inventory of over 100,000 products. Experts like Jack, Ann, and Jim design, configure, and deliver even the most complex IT solutions. From a single notebook to enterprise networks, Insight delivers more products, expertise, and value, even financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
My name is Jimmy Lancaster.
David Bolden. Sergeant Lancaster and myself both served in Afghanistan together. Being in top physical condition is a necessity, so it took both of us with us.
We had all seen the commercials but never had used one before. And this reaction to working out on the Bowflex was, it was a tremendous machine. Everybody in our camp wanted to use the Bowflex. And you can go heavy, you can do a lightweight workout, you can max yourself out on the Bowflex.
Well, the thing I say to guys who are skeptical of boat flex is try it.
Try it out and see what you think.
It's a very effective piece of fitness equipment that anybody can benefit from, no matter what your fitness level is. I use boat flex, and that's all I use.
The boat flex kept us mentally focused as well as physically.
They helped us stay in shape, and staying in shape helped us do our jobs.
Call and ask for a free video and brochure, and check out the entire boat flex lineup, or visit us on the web today. Boat flex, real results. The Gospel, according to ESPN, a great holiday gift.
Capital One Bowl Week from Phoenix as Pittsburgh and Oregon State continue the first quarter tied at 7. They ruled Rutherford's progress down at the 45, and Andy Lee popped this one down to the 24, where it's fair caught by Eric Williams. Just 20 yards on this one.
I guess he wanted to hang it up in the air.
Not like that.
No.
Eric Anderson, sophomore from Scappoose, Oregon, now the all-time Beaver single-season passing leader with that 79-yard start he has tonight. Came in 147 total yards from Jonathan Smith's Oregon State single-season record. Smith now a graduate assistant on Denver Syracuse staff. So a little bit of a gift after the short punt, and Jackson off tackle. And a gain of 9. Friday night, the NBA season continues on ESPN2. 7:30 Eastern, the pregame NBA scoreboard. And then at 8 Eastern, Ray Allen and the Milwaukee Bucks and East Rutherford. They'll take on Jason Kidd and defending the Eastern Conference champion, New Jersey Nets, who took apart the Boston Celtics yesterday by 36, and it wasn't that close.
Tell you what, incredible what's going on in the NBA, and especially out there in L.A. with the Lakers. Off the start there, and
at home last night to Sacramento. Second down and 1 carry by Jackson. And runs right into Lewis Moore, but should have the first down by about a foot or so.
Where I think Oregon State is going to need to try and establish some of the running game and try and establish Steven Jackson as a threat. I know we put up the numbers of Derek Anderson, but he's only completed right at 47% of his passes this year overall. So if the game is relying on his arm, it could be a struggle for Oregon State. They need to get this man going so that they can work the play action off of him.
Jackson out of Las Vegas. Harrison says that's an under-recruited area, and he thought Jackson was a little bit under-recruited, although he was player of the year in Nevada, and they feature him on this series, his third straight carry out to the 43. Jackson, as just a sophomore, fifth in the country. Everybody chased Larry Johnson. Had Michael Turner, the least known. Chris Brown, Willis McGahee, big names, and Steven Jackson will get bigger. With 2 more years available to him in the program, no telling where he'll end up.
That's not a happy thought for linebacker, but you can see right now, you can see his acceleration.
They throw on second and short, and it's caught by Kenny Farley, the slot receiver, with his first grab of the night for the 48 of the Panthers. A little more on Steven Jackson from Dave Ryan.
Well, Dave, there are a lot of similarities with Steven Jackson. And a certain running back with the Miami Dolphins who's tearing up the NFL this year, Ricky Williams. Steven Jackson has always looked up to Ricky, wears the same number 34, has a very similar haircut, and he uses a face shield as well, just like Ricky. At this rate, he may be a number one NFL draft pick as well down the road.
He's got a shot at that.
You could find worse role models.
Yeah, as long as when he starts doing the interviews, he takes the helmet off.
Yeah, Ricky does that.
I know he does.
Back to Jackson. And a couple of hard fought yards. He estimates that the old-fashioned stiff arm weapon has given him about 600 of his 1,656 yards coming in. Now, 38 yards to become number 5 on the all-time Pac-10 single-season list. Facing down O.J. Simpson. But we haven't seen it yet, but when he unveils it, you'll know it, because it is the bane, especially of defensive backs who have to try and deal with that thing.
It's no fun seeing film the next day if you got stiff-armed to the ground.
It's just like that left jab.
And Paul Rhodes, defensive coordinator for Pittsburgh, says there's really no way to deal with it once he gets it up. Hanging this one deep. too deep by a couple of yards for Newsom, who had blown past Torrey Cox. Didn't hang it high enough. Third and seven.
This guy has got a wonderful arm. He really, in his delivery, reminds me of Byron Leftwich, the great Marshall quarterback. Just a little more pop on it, he's saying, come on, Derek, just hang it up. Just give me a little more, maybe a step or two to run under that thing. Derek's got the adrenaline going, and he's a little pumped right now, but he'll bring those under control as the game progresses. And we're going to see a very interesting contest of two well-oiled offenses here.
Promising drive, but now they need seven on third down. And they come with a safety blitz. Anderson in time, complete. Sean Kittner with the catch, and it's a 32. An Oregon State first down, a gain of 14.
Can't do it. Can't play off that much. Torrey Cox playing off way too much. Tez Morris gets the pressure on Anderson. He stays in there, throws it. He knows it's coming. He knows the pressure's coming right up in the face.
Well, the reason he played off is because of the free safety blitz. Tez Morris came from a depth of 11 yards, got the late hit. But Torrey Cox wasn't about to get up there and let Newsom run by him again. That's why he's playing off.
Well, first and 10, bottom line. Back to the running game, Jackson. Panthers shadow him pretty well now, and no gain. Vince Krochunas joined by Gerald Hayes.
Hayes is going to be a man you're going to see playing on Sundays as well. A big, tough middle linebacker. He can fill. He can run sideline to sideline. He can take on blocks. Good little rip underneath. Getting by Sanchez. Getting himself to the ball. Again, good size to play the middle in the NFL.
The yard and stumbling out of the gate, Anderson will lose a few more,
and they'll have to convert another third and long, but it'll be the first play of the second quarter.
Excuse me, Dave. You wonder how in the world can a thing like that happen. That's a screw up between Matt Block, the center, and the quarterback, Anderson. It's a footwork thing. Anderson's got to get his right foot out of the way. As Block needs to step back to pass protect, the quarterback's right foot should automatically come back. We've seen more of that this year, and I think the reason is because there's so many gun snaps that these teams don't work as much on the center-quarterback exchange in the normal fashion. So centers and quarterbacks' footwork is not quite as well coordinated as it normally would have been in the past.
Larry Fitzgerald made one catch. It was for 40 yards, full layout to get Pittsburgh on the board. Oregon State then answered on a 65-yard catch and run by James Newsom. A spectacular first quarter exchange, and we'll head to the second, tied at seven.
Which sports center do you watch? Mornings, evenings, late nights, only on ESPN.
I'm at my mother's for dinner. She says, wasn't that chili unbelievable? I say, unbelievable. Where's the Alka-Seltzer?
Only Alka-Seltzer's effervescent power relieves indigestion and pain fast.
Get better relief. Get Alka-Seltzer.
America's top critics are united in their praise for Gangs of New York. Rolling Stone magazine raves it's the best picture of the year, and now it's been nominated for 5 Golden Globe Awards, including Best Picture of the Year. Gangs of New York, rated R. Now playing everywhere.
We all lead such busy lives. But there is a place where redwoods stand tall and time flows slowly. Redwood Creek, where the tradition of slowing down and taking time has never been forgotten. An unhurried approach to winemaking that leads to a richer, more full-bodied taste. Redwood Creek, because good things take time.
Mr. Moneybag?
It's okay. I put it on the credit card.
Those interest charges are going to get us.
Don't worry. It's our new Capital One No Hassle card.
The Capital One No Hassle card has the nation's lowest long-term fixed rates, $0 fraud liability, and no telemarketing.
All around the world, Siemens provides hospitals and doctors with the tools they need to make the right decisions right away. From diagnostics to patient information to care management, we're doing our part to help people everywhere feel better.
Part of the crowd of around 6,000 or so who have come down from Corvallis, Oregon State fans looking at a 7-7 first quarter tie. Thanks to Larry Fitzgerald and James Newsom. We'll begin the second quarter with the third and long, 15 to be exact, facing the Beaver offense. Trying not to get bogged down here now that they've reached Panther territory. Kitzer, who converted the last third down, wide left. And Anderson looking his way. He's intended for Farley, incomplete. If he had continued to look Kittner's way, he broke on a post wide open at the goal line. But Anderson turned his attention elsewhere.
He had his attention there the whole way, too, and that's a problem for Anderson. Again, completing just 47% of his passes. He locked on to Farley in that route. Dave, you're absolutely right. He looks down the middle of the field. They're winning this ball game.
Instead, they're punting. Carl Tobey out. Sean Robinson deep. Toby trying to do what Lee did last time, hang about a 20-yarder up, and hammers it well beyond the end line. 36, he'll net 16. RSPN game track. We'll never get tired of looking at that. The true freshman from Minneapolis hit a home run, and then Newsom answered. Now, the elbow was down.
Yep.
Bill, what does the rule book say about
this? I was wrong. Our boss, Mo Davenport, called when any part of the runner's body except his hand or foot touches the ground, or when the runner is tackled or otherwise falls and loses possession of the ball, he is down. So I was wrong. The boss is right.
Should have been down at midfield. Should still be 7-0 Pittsburgh, as it turns out. We'll show you again. A clear angle here.
Here it is again, and it's something that obviously the officials didn't understand the rule. I would have called it the same way the officials would have. He is down right there. When that elbow touches the ground, anything other than the foot and the hand, and in 48 years of football, you would think I would have learned that.
That's all right, Bill. You got another 48 still to go.
I hope so.
Second down and 7. And 3 wide. Myrie with the toss for the short side. Nice wiggle at about the 23, and that gets him about 4 extra yards. Pittsburgh has a major loss to deal with, and that is the loss of their athletic director, Steve Peterson, to the University of Nebraska. Steve Peterson is with Dave Ryan.
All right, Dave, we're quite ready. Now we are, Steve. How difficult has it been over the past couple days for you? I know you're heading off to Nebraska pretty soon, but still this is a big game for the Pittsburgh program. What are the emotions like for you right now?
Well, you know, it's always hard when you come back and you see the kids and our staff. We have such a great staff, but this is the way I wanted to spend some time with them. This has been a great 3 days of being with them and getting a chance to see one of them. We were together on Christmas. You know, I guess if you're going to leave, you couldn't leave with a better scenario than this.
An amazing turnaround of the program when you got to Pittsburgh 6 years ago, Steve. The Peterson Event Center, the brand new Heinz Field, practice facilities for basketball and football. Did you think 6 years ago you could build the dream so quickly?
Well, I think there were times where I was the only one that believed that, and maybe they thought I was a little crazy, but we kept saying if we work hard and we had a good plan and we kept going forward with the plan, and fortunately, more and more people begin to believe, and we've got tremendous coaches, we got a great staff, and they all pitched in, and our principles have been commitment, teamwork, and pride, and we have been teamwork people all the way along. That's what's great about this organization. Everybody does it together, everybody believes in each other, and we've said all along, nobody's more or less important than anybody else. We got to have everybody on the same team to get it done.
Thanks for your time, Steve.
Great.
Native of North Platte, Nebraska, and a Husker alum going back home, Dave.
And he will be missed, and boy, did he ever reshape the landscape of University of Pittsburgh athletics. Defensive holding call on that scramble by Rutherford, and so they'll move up to the 44 with a first down. Moved into Heinz Field, moved into the new basketball arena, and they've got a top 5 level basketball program. We'll see where football ends up. If they win, they'll be somewhere in the top 25.
Rutherford again protected extremely well. Hangs that one up, and the receiver slips down as Dennis Weathersby also loses his footing. Marcus Furman can't take advantage of it.
Yeah, when your feet tangle like that, they're not going to call it, nor should they. It was a slip here by the receiver. See Weathersby again, a nice job. That's his forte, right at the line of scrimmage. Just slipping, no call, easy no call there. Want to keep going on that with the AD leaving, but what Walt Harris, the starter, guys, remember his last year before being the head coach, he was an assistant at Ohio State that put a 72-0 whooping on Pittsburgh in 96. Walt Harris takes over the program now 6 years later. They're 24 points away from being undefeated this year.
One play in each of their four losses. Furman makes this catch and then immediately brought down by Weathersby. Four losses by an average of 6 points a game, the biggest 8 points. Against the Notre Dame team, they outgained by 400 to about 185-yard margin. They rolled up huge statistical advantages on Miami, twice as many first downs, about twice the time of possession. They were throwing into the end zone for a tie at the end of that game. And then gave up a late big play and lost the backyard ball to West Virginia. Extra point misses cost them the Texas A&M game. So they are just a hair away from a spectacular season. Mutes a hair away, probably from a 55-yard touchdown interception return.
And Mutes's been laying back in the middle. And what Oregon State's doing on defense is they're lining up in a zero coverage at times, meaning no free safety, and they're just going man-to-man and they're blitzing. Then they're leaving Houston in the middle of the field, and they're playing man-free, meaning there's a free safety with five under man. And the quarterback tends to forget about that guy, and he almost plucked it and went the distance there.
He's had one big, one bad punt. This one is huge. And Eric Williams backs up into his end zone. Boy, does he avoid absolute disaster. You're not supposed to back up inside your 10. He was 12 yards beyond there. A 52-yard punt by Lee. He brings it back 10. Wow. Still 7-7.
This is how most computer products arrive at your business. And this is what's left after the box is unpacked. At Insight, account executives help you find the products you need at the best prices. Hundreds of certified technicians and engineers design, configure, test, and install your IT equipment. Whether you're buying for a home office or one of the Fortune 1000, you get the best combination of product expertise and price. Right down to financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
The Dodge SXT. Four cool cars. And you won't have to work two jobs just to buy one.
Dodge! You made
it! I like your hat.
Grab Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it.
This thing you carry with you everywhere. This thing you obsess about and face ridicule for. This thing you're not sure that you'll ever be able to quit may have just met its match. Introducing the new Commit Lozenge, an FDA-approved medicine that has the power to help fight your addiction. Its medicine keeps working, even after the lozenge is gone. You use less and less, until you use none. Imagine if this thing were just a thing. The new Commit Lozenge. Real power. Real help.
Homer.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes. Nice.
Yes.
It only bounced twice.
No, I cured it.
So what?
It's a home run.
No, yeah, it's a double.
No, it didn't even hit the back of the shell.
It's a home run.
It's a double.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about rules. Doesn't hit
those
back,
aren't the rules. You're talking
double.
About making up the rules.
No, okay. I'm talking about, look, I play with shoes, you don't.
So
that's
what?
That's a rule.
I have a medical condition. This is why no one wants to play with you.
Why? Because I'm right and I'm better at it than that.
Curt Schilling wouldn't approve. But it's a nice enough night, a little on the cool side, to have the roof open at the Bob. What happens here? Eric Williams, what's he thinking?
Well, you put a veteran guy like Eric Williams at the 10-yard line, and you say, don't back up, no matter what. Well, you don't practice this. You go for 40 days or so without playing a football game because you're in a bowl, and Eric's standing there, and he backs up. He thinks he's backed up 2 yards. He's not supposed to back up at all, and he backs up 12.
So bad field position for Oregon State.
Anderson pump fake going deep. Newsom overthrown. And Mike, again, not enough air under it.
Got to lay that ball up a little more, no doubt about it. Put some air in it. But let's go back and see what happened on the sidelines. And Williams goes there. Coaches, a little discussion. Let's see, if your feet are on the 10 and you back up, don't catch the ball. Is that what they're saying, Bill?
They say don't back up.
Yeah.
Period. Let the ball hit if it's the 8-yard line, if it's the 6, because the odds are it's going to go into the end zone for the touchback.
That back is almost turned into a safety. Cost him 10 yards. And second and 10, right up the middle, Steven Jackson. Close to breaking that one.
He almost popped that thing because of the blitz tendency. They're not playing with a free safety part of the time. Both these defenses are playing almost identically in terms of scheme. If one of these backs can pop it through untouched at the line of scrimmage, he's going to run a long way.
7-7 game in Phoenix. Moved this game a few years ago from Tucson. Run fairly well. They have about 41,900 seats available for this football alignment. 6,000 less than for baseball. And, you know, none were available by kickoff. On third and 5, they beat the blitz and a nice over-the-shoulder toss to the tight end, Tim Ewers, who then loses it, scrambled at the 42.
I think he might have got it back. Possibly. What a fantastic throw by Anderson. Let's see. I guarantee you there's some fighting going on under there.
This is 42 yards if it stands. And it does.
He did. I think he got it back.
He did.
What an great job by the throw. What a touch. Pop. You talk about getting a little air. He's a little nice little pop right over the top to Ewers. Excellent throw. Good recovery by Humphreys. He comes in there with the arm and causes the fumble, but Ewers ends up with it again.
The problem is the ball is out there loose. He's not securing it well. It's popped out, and you will not see a more fortuitous fall in this entire game than that one. He fell right on the football. Tim Ewers, a very lucky young man.
42 yards to the 42. Another play fake. Anderson. Deep ball, batted up in the air, and then defended by Kintner, the intended receiver, just to make sure nobody in a white jersey got it.
Well, here again you see Anderson locking on, going back to Kintner. He was in double coverage, but Anderson was throwing it there anyway, almost tipped it right to him. Wow. That would have been something if he pulled that thing in.
Almost pulled that thing in. I'll tell you, these two quarterbacks are so exciting. They're so much fun to watch. For somewhat different reasons, this was a little bit errant throw, but Anderson's got tremendous potential.
They're just keeping that away from Gary Ursler. To the ground, Jackson, hit by Brian Guzik at the line, and falls forward for a couple. Another third and long coming. Capital One Bowl Week continuing tomorrow. ESPN has a triple header beginning with College Game Day's Bowl Special presented by Outback at noon Eastern. 1 o'clock, Southern Miss Oklahoma State from Reliant Stadium in the Houston Bowl at 4:30 Eastern, Eli Manning at Ole Miss. And Nebraska, the 27th Mainstay Independence Bowl from Shreveport. Finishing up out west in San Diego, the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl with number 6 Kansas State against Arizona State. Third and 8 blitz. Anderson, a strike over the middle and a first down to the 30. Cole Clayson with his first catch and it's good for 10 yards.
Same defense, man coverage, this time with no free safety because they're bringing the blitz. Corey Humphreys in man coverage on Cole Clayson. Clayson pops inside, a perfect throw. Nice job by Anderson. Good execution and concentration by Clayson for the first down. And one missed tackle, folks, I'll repeat. And these things are touchdowns.
This drive that began at their own 10 on the punt, fielded 2 yards deep in the end zone, has now reached the Panthers 30. Jackson hit behind the line by Vince Krochunas.
Well, you talked before the game, Bill, and talked about how they need to try and free up Hayes with these D tackles and nose tackles making penetration. This time the tight end Tim Ewis gets off on Hayes, gets a nice little piece of cloth as well. But you know what? The guys up front did the job that time. Fortuitous makes nice penetration to make the play behind the line. As Hayes tries to make it over there, he'll have plenty more than four tackles tonight, I guarantee you that.
Second down and 11, Jackson again. Same result. Warm by Panthers. Guzik first, then Lewis Moore.
Here's what the defenses are saying to the offenses. You are not going to run the football. We're going to blitz and stunt and slant, and we're going to get in the gap, and we're going to keep you from getting it to those big backs and grinding us into fine powder. You want to take a chance throwing it? Take your chances. We're going to take our chances. That's what the defenses are doing, and they're a little bit of a gamble, but it's fun to watch.
Four of the offensive linemen for Oregon State over 300 pounds, including Kuykendall at 324 and Sanchez at 340. So you're right, Bill. This D-line is doing some nice stuff and hitting the gap.
Ollie Quicken. As a result, Jackson has only 22 yards on his first 10 carries. Anderson hit and incomplete. The arm going forward. Incomplete pass. Lewis Moore coming on a blitz.
And he really, he took a hit from both sides and well, he's thinking, all right, he's getting up and running off the field. That's a good sign because he took it on the blind side and the front side. Thomas Smith and Lewis Moore, oh, boy, they just bent him. Oh, you see the knee bent back, but he got up and ran off the field. That's a good, good sign.
Well, they're out to try a 49-yard field goal, and Kirk Iloniemi has made 13 straight, a school record for a single season. He has this one long enough and make it 14 straight.
And he's made a 50-yarder before, so it's no big deal to him.
Well, he's a walk-on. They finally have found a scholarship for him, but he's got to wait till next year. 14 out of 15 on the season. And he's given the Beavers their first lead in the inside bowl.
This is Gladys. Gladys works for a big computer reseller. When she's done selling, this is what you're left with. Jennifer works at Insight. She helps you find the product you need at prices you like from an inventory of over 100,000 products. Experts like Jack, Ann, and Jim design, configure, and deliver even the most complex IT solutions. From a single notebook to enterprise networks, Insight delivers more products, expertise, and value, even financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
Chrysler invites you to preview our holiday collection, featuring our best-selling collection of minivans, now with a special holiday bonus. Now, choose one of three Sony personal entertainment packages when you buy any new Town & Country minivan. Plus, get 0% financing for 60 months on select minivans. Or choose cash allowances up to $3,500. But hurry, this invitation ends January 2nd, so see your Chrysler dealer today.
Homeowners, what would you do to avoid the stress of qualifying for a home loan?
Anything.
AmeriQuest Mortgage understands why you hesitate, and that's why we've made getting a loan so easy. With two decades of experience, AmeriQuest has perfected the art of the no-stress home loan. To experience that for yourself, call AmeriQuest at 1-800-542-9130 or go to AmeriQuest.com. That's 1-800-542-9130. Call AmeriQuest, the company that knows you are more.
It's the most wonderful week of the year.
Friday, Jamal Lord and Nebraska's high-speed ground game square off against Eli Manning and the Ole Miss air attack. And later, L. Roberson leads K-State's powerhouse offense against Sackmaster Terrell Suggs and the Sun Devils. Nebraska, Mississippi in the Mainstay Independence Bowl at 4:30. Kansas State, Arizona State in the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl at 8. Capital One Bowl Week continues Friday on ESPN.
Well, just about 10 miles from here, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl will take place at Sun Devil Stadium on the Arizona State campus. January 3rd, Miami, Ohio State. Corey Cox. And the return to the 25. But before the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, the bowl championship series kicks off on ABC with the historic matchup between Big 12 champ Oklahoma
in the Rose Bowl for the first time ever against Pac-10 champ Washington State. The Rose Bowl presented by PlayStation 2, 4:30 Eastern, 1:30 Pacific on ABC Sports Championship TV. If you can't get to a TV, ESPN Radio, of course, has nationwide coverage. 10-7, Pittsburgh trailing for the first time, midway in the second quarter. Rod Rutherford, a play fake, and the second catch by Fitzgerald. Out to the 32-yard line, a gain of six, tackled by Nick Barnett and Dennis Weathersby.
That's what needs to happen with this passing offense. It's got to be more on rhythm. You've seen when Pittsburgh has struggled, if Rutherford has held on to the ball, it's been excellent coverage by Oregon State, who led the Pac-10, giving up only 200 yards a game through the air, led by that man as well, Weathersby, who's a career record, 61 passes defense for the Beavers.
They just want to get to the third down. They figure they got you at that point. Second and four. And Myrie, with the give out of the shotgun, spins ahead to the 42. And a gain of 10 yards from Myrie at this point, winning the matchup with Stephen Jackson rather handily.
That free safety sitting back there, Mitch Musin, has a job to do. When that back pops it, his job is to get him on the ground one way or another, and it wasn't a pretty tackle, but he got the job done.
That's no fun when you're back there, isn't it?
Oh,
you
no.
See that back pop through?
Big tank comes through now. But the guys up front are getting a hand on him, slowing him up a little, helping out just enough.
Myrie out rushing Jackson, 68. Rutherford again well protected. That's incomplete. Marcus Furman didn't have it. Incomplete pass. Let's send it down to Dave Ryan.
All right, Dave, special guest Tim Brown, the CEO of Insight Enterprises, with us. The big question we all have with our ESPN crew, Tim, why the change? Insight.com Bowl the first 5 years, Insight Bowl this year. How come?
We're more than just a great website. We're 5,000 people around the world solving business customers' problems.
Answer, and you've got quite a few of your employees here as well, some 3,000 watching the game tonight.
Absolutely. The entire bleacher section across the field are all Insight employees and their families.
Dave, locally based company, Tempe is 2 miles away.
Second down and 10 with four wide. And Rutherford again stepping up to keep. Out to the 48. Interesting to hear Walt Harris say that in some ways he's not as good a runner as he was when he was a poorer passer. When he was a 31% passer, he was a better running threat.
I think they'll take the passing, wouldn't you think, Bill?
Well, they like the combination. I mean, he can still run well. He was a great runner before because he thought about running. Now he thinks about where he's going to throw, and the run is an afterthought, and that's what you want in an outstanding quarterback, and he is certainly that.
Now, here's a third down. Beavers in the last two games gave up only 3 of 26. Third down conversion. Slade makes the catch inbound. Pretty pass. And an easy catch, as it turned out, as Rutherford drops it right over his shoulder in front of Calvin Carlisle in a gain of 17.
Well, called it incomplete. Now the referee's had a discussion, and he's saying he had a foot out of bounds.
Wow, that was a Dennis Erickson call. Dennis walked down there and talked to the official.
Is that right? Right foot.
Hard to tell.
An official right there. I mean, he is looking right at it. He is the one who eventually overruled the other official as they talked. He said, nope, his foot was on the out-of-bounds line.
Now, that's the strangest call I've seen in a long time.
It'd be a lot more convincing if he had said it immediately.
Yeah. Yeah,
either it is or it isn't.
So, Andy Lee off this one, which is a little easier for Williams to deal with because he didn't have to back up inside the 10.
Here comes the flag, the halo rule. And that's going to be a 10-yard penalty.
Corey Cox got down there.
This is another close call because it looked to me like Cox had it timed extremely well. And that's the goal. When you're one of those gunners, when you're one of those guys coming down on the outside as Cox is, you want to be a little... The unintent, 2 yards.
Interference with the opportunity, 2 yards off. About 10 yards from end of run.
And in the judgment of the officials, he was obviously just inside the 2 yards. Let's take a look here. We have the benefit of
great play. Oh, well, that's awfully close.
Yes, it is. But they'll move it out of the 24. And from that point, Oregon State with a 10-7 lead, 5:43 to go in the first half of the inside bowl from Bank One Ballpark.
College basketball on ESPN. Take it to the rack with a full day of high-intensity matchups.
Good racing. Look out!
First, the Bluegrass rivalry heats up again as Keith Bogan leads Kentucky against Rick Pitino's Louisville squad, led by sweet shooting Reed Gaines. Then Bobby Knight is back in the Big Ten as his Red Raiders and their main man Andre Emmett face Minnesota. College hoops all day Saturday on ESPN and ESPN2.
Difference between Quick Lane Tire and Auto Repair and all others is night and day. Only Quick Lane is open all day and all night, which means Quick Lane's factory trained technicians and state-of-the-art equipment are available to you day and night. Quick Lane also offers free towing and free loaners. All work is guaranteed and all services are covered by this low price guarantee. Get front or rear brakes now for just $99. Quick Lane, the difference is day and night. 1/2 mile north of I-55 on Route 83 in the Woodlawn Plaza next to Dunkin' Donuts.
Get extra storage in minutes with Plano Shelving from Menards. This 18-inch deep 5-shelf model is $28.88. A 24-inch deep unit is $34.98. For heavy-duty storage, check out Gorilla Rack Steel Shelving. Great for garages, workshops, or businesses. Create your own custom storage. All Gorilla Rack components are on sale. Plus, save an extra 10% on everything, even sale items, when you put it on your Menards big car.
Save big money at Menards.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2002 Insight Bowl, presented by Insight. Only Insight delivers the best combination of computer products, services, and price. Insight, whatever it takes. And in part by Chrysler, drive equals love.
And back inside the Bob, Dave Barnett, Mike Golick, Bill Curry, Dave Ryan. 10-7, and Oregon State takes it from their 24 with 5:43 to go in the first half. Lags and whistles before Steven Jackson. A little bit of movement. Make it first and 15.
Fired a step. Defense in the neutral zone. Causing the offense to move. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
And we get close to halftime, at which time we'll have the Dodge halftime report. And look at what Boston College did at Toledo in the Motor City Bowl. A preview of Arizona State, Kansas State, the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl, as well as Ole Miss, Nebraska, the Main State Independence Bowl.
Like I said, first and five.
You said something like that. Yeah. It's time to fake to Jackson. And the deep ball, he overthrows Newsom again. That's three times. That is three times that Derek Anderson has lacked air underneath to get James Newsom a chance to run under that. So it's 10-7. It could be a lot worse than 10-7.
Well, it could, but here's what Pittsburgh is saying to Oregon State. You're not going to beat us running the ball. We're going to make Anderson beat us with his arm, and right now we don't think he can do it. And Newton's going back saying, please, just take a little off. I think I can get this guy.
That's exactly right. He's throwing it up on the other side of the ball. Rutherford in the pocket either needs to make that quick throw or take off and run because he can run pretty effectively.
Second down and five. Back to Jackson. Bottled up again. That's actually one of his better runs. And he'll be close to the first down.
Yeah, he made 3 yards. And he's used to ripping people. Now, you got to understand, this guy is accustomed to averaging 5.5 yards per carry. And Oregon State has said, we're going to run him with the football. We don't care if there are 9 of them up there in the box.
Well, this guy's close to 230 pounds, and Pittsburgh does not want him running north and south. As you see the comparison between the two, Myrie outrushing Jackson at this point.
Jackson with almost exactly twice as many yards as Myrie coming in tonight. Good having up for the first. And back into the crowd. It has not been much fun this first half for Steven Jackson.
Well, what they're making him do is they're making him dance.
And you said it earlier, Bill, with that D-line and linebackers, either the run blitz or the stunts up front with the line hitting the gaps on that big Oregon State offensive line. You want to make Jackson dance east and west before he could pick up a head of steam and use that stiff arm, which he talked about, which we have not seen tonight. Pittsburgh is doing an excellent job bottling him up.
He wants to be an architect, not a dancer. He also wants to run through some holes, and he's not getting much help from his friends up front tonight.
2 yards there. Trying to the short side of the field. Undercut before he can get the stiff arm out by Torrey Cox. Back down to Dave Ryan.
Steve Jackson carries around a notebook all the time and actually jots down certain notes, little ideas he might have for that career in architecture. He'd like to build someday a five-story house, not sure how many bedrooms. He wants a jacuzzi, a basketball court, a movie theater as well. And if he keeps playing this way, NFL career, I think that's all possible.
I'm still drawing stick figures.
Is that what those are?
Well, supposed to be.
That's very impressive. That's a casino pit box. Mom used to be a 21 dealer. Grab at midfield, Newsom, and hang it off for dear life, Sean Robinson.
I'll tell you, Newsom is a load now. He must have gone back to the coaches to forget about those deep balls. Derek's not throwing them very well. Just let me have it anywhere in front of these guys. I'll rip away from them. Nice route, good timing. Look at the throw, still just a shade high, but look how strong Newsom is. Sean Robinson literally hanging on for dear life.
Joseph said he just can't even try to bump him. It's not even worth the effort. No one's been able to all year. Well, if you can bring him down by themselves. Robinson just barely managed to. And now Jackson knocked backwards again. He'll lose two. Gerald Hayes getting the better of this matchup so far.
Well, I tell you what, again, a great load. He can either take on that block or slip through if he's protected. See, Reed diagnosed him getting around the block. Ewis again trying to get the hold. This time can't do it. Hayes gets his shoulders around him and squared to the line of scrimmage. That is key. Excellent job of body movement with Ewis, the tight end, having the angle on.
Ewis is trying to grab him and drag him down. Trying to hold him. Didn't hold him.
And split out wide left. Anderson goes the other way and off the hands of Kenny Farley, the second leading receiver for the Beavers. It'll be third and 12.
Farley's another big, strong-looking guy. All these guys, are just not all of them, but virtually all of them. Sean Kittner, number 10, Newsom. The big old 6'1", 6'2", 6'3", guys, over 200 pounds, and these defensive backs are physically outmanned when they have to try to tackle.
He's just getting to playing now, coming in the huddle. He's going to have to hurry. This is one of these situations you never really like. You get to the line and you kind of get rushed.
Jackson again comes out wide left. One-on-one with Cox. Down to one, and Anderson didn't see it. And did he get timeout called in time? I really don't think he did, but they're going to give it to him.
Yeah, I mean, if you're going to run out that late to the huddle, you've got to be aware of that clock counting down.
Only one more timeout for Dennis Erickson. 2:34 left in a half.
This is how most computer products arrive at your business. And this is what's left after the box is unpacked. At Insight, account executives help you find the products you need at the best prices. Hundreds of certified technicians and engineers design, configure, test, and install your IT equipment. Whether you're buying for a home office or one of the Fortune 1000, you get the best combination of products, expertise, and price. Right down to financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
Safer.
In the most wonderful time of the year.
all season. We waited our faces, I painted the playoffs. I mean, it's the most wonderful time of the year. With Super Bowl dreaming and chilling and screaming, big plays and cold beer. It's the most wonderful time.
Cool off the Sun Devils. Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl, Friday at 8 on ESPN.
Crowd here at the Bob, somewhere around 42,000. We also want to welcome the men and women serving proudly in the 235th Base Support Battalion in Ansbach, Germany. Watching the Inside Bowl on AFM, the American Forces Network. Happy holidays from all of us at ESPN. Hope you had a good one. Hope you're enjoying this one. 10-7 Oregon State, they have a 3rd and 12. And they have a blitz on Anderson. Fires it off the hands of Farley. And then blasted for good measure by Tez Morris. Anderson got some of the same treatment from Brian Beinecke.
Well, when it's 3rd and 11, you hang back, you let him throw the ball, and then you deliver a smack. That sounds a little something like this.
Oh, boy. And that's what that free safety's back there for in pass, to break that up.
Toby sends this one down to the 16. Fair caught there by Robinson. And let's hear from Chris Fowler. What you got in store for us at the half?
Well, Dave, a strong opening statement by the Big East. The Motor City mashing by Boston College. We'll have some highlights of that. Tell you whether or not Arizona State has a good chance against K-State in the Holiday Bowl tomorrow. And the Buckeyes joining you guys in the Phoenix area in preparation, of course, for the Casino CS Bowl. Coming up the Dodge Halftime Report.
It was a nice sunny day today, but it's been kind of yucky, cloudy, rainy, very cold.
I got here Sunday, went to Pittsburgh practice Monday. It was 43 and raining. It was brutal. Guys said they could have stayed in Pittsburgh for that.
Well, there's a, why did I bring my shorts in shade? Rutherford, the out that they ruled out of bounds. Last series, they ruled inbounds to Lamar Slade this time.
Tough throw to make, and a beautiful throw by Rutherford. He showed presence in the pocket, and this is why they don't want him running out of there. He had to stand. There was a foot down prior. Slade got a foot down before that one that you saw step on the line, so that was a really well-executed throw and catch. Again, against man coverage.
Beautiful night tonight. Well, they're dropping down in the 40s, though. Rutherford gets it to Myrie on the screen, and Brandon Myrie's legs do the rest. Well, it's a nice downfield block by Lamar Slade. Finally caught by Musin, a gain of 25.
But what started it was Dan LeCarte out there holding on to his block on Eric Tuma. This is what gets the play going. A little shot, quick shot out there at first for Rutherford. LeCarte holds the block to spring Myrie.
Just like that, they've reached the Beaver 41. Rutherford overthrows a leaping Marcus Furman. Roosevelt Bynes quit the team before the bowl practices began. He was their third leading receiver, gone, and so Marcus Furman has been elevated, getting a lot more playing time than he was used to during the season.
Yeah. Rutherford's been watching Anderson too much. Now he's got his eyeball working. He threw that one off the backstop, folks. That one just got away. Short home plate, too.
That's Fitzgerald in motion. Rutherford looks his way, has him, and wrapped up immediately by Terrell Roberts. Senior second team all Pac-10 corner. And who was it that lost that shoe? That was Slade. But he's got time for a little bit of repair. Time out with a minute. 42 to go. 10-7, but Pittsburgh driving.
K-State's powerhouse offense looks to cool off the Sun Devils. Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl, Friday at 8 on ESPN.
With its new available Power Stroke diesel and 5-speed automatic torque shift transmission that generates 560 pound-feet of torque and 325 horsepower, the
for duty. Pulls faster and easier than any other diesel pickup. Ford F-Series. The best-selling truck on the planet.
Well, guess that settles that.
Yep.
It's built Ford tough.
Looks like fifth intern's moving up.
Promotion?
Oh, yeah, I'm on the fast track. Corner office, parking space. I totally deserve it.
How do you figure?
Well, look what I've learned. Dell helps people build their perfect PC to make it easy to order, and they have award-winning 24/7 service and support. You'll probably be reporting to me. Check it out. This is to notify you that our latest promotion...
Some people just should not try this.
Go ahead, get back up here in the box.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, that's tough.
Wow. I move like that, I'll be winded.
I thought he was pretty good. For a guy with a mustache.
What does the mustache have to do with
I didn't even want to ask, Dave. I just stayed away from it.
Third and six for the Panthers. 1:50 Rutherford gets away from the first hit, but not the second. Still fights to get the ball off and did, and it's incomplete. Not intentional grounding because it was near Myrie.
Yeah, it was also a very bad wrist. There were a lot of black shirts over there around Myrie, and even though he came out of it smelling like a rose, he could have had a very different kind of scent after this. You need to just take your lumps here. Don't throw that ball up in the air. He had no idea what he was doing with it, and it could have gone the other way.
Well,
it
would be like about a 55-yard field goal, 54-yard field goal. Duel's longest is 47, so they're not going to risk anything here. Lee's going to kick this time to Terrell Roberts and not Eric Williams, who backs up 2 yards into the end zone to field one early. Roberts does the right thing. He runs away from it when he sees it's going to be inside the 10, and it's down at about the 2 by Cox. So it worked out well for Lee, 33 yards, and they'll mark it at the 3.
Great job by Cox, who went into the end zone, turned, and came back toward the ball to down it at the 1. With this field position, it's a long way, but this is excellent kicking game presence by Torrey Cox, who actually has run into the end zone, comes back out. We didn't get to see him go in and come back out, but as he did that, he's back on the orange part, so he can see the ball come out, and when he touches it, that ball is dead at that spot.
Jackson. Here again. Hit usually right at the line of scrimmage. He gets two or three as he does here. It's on his own.
Excuse me, David, but another observation. Jackson's not breaking any tackles. Pittsburgh's doing an excellent job of hitting the big guy, 230 pounds, wrapping him up, and the first tackler's bringing him down.
Pittsburgh calls time here because they want the ball back one more time, figuring they're going to get great field position if they can keep Oregon State bottled up and force the punt. Fitzgerald with the first touchdown. Pretty a dive as you'll ever see, a 40-yard catch. Jackson has managed, on the other hand, only 33 yards on the ground. Look at it one more time.
Oh, we're going to be seeing this thing a long time. This is going to be on all the highlights, as are about half of his catches.
It's a 15-foot dive. Five-yard line.
5 yards and lands in the end zone. He really does make you think of the great NFL players like Jerry Rice, like Chris Carter, that taught him how to run routes as he was a ball boy up there with the Vikings for 6 years.
And that just ended a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
His junior year in high school, he was hanging out with the Chris Carters and Randy Mosses running routes with these guys. So that's why I said at the top of the show, he's ahead of his years in maturity in the football game. Newsom wide left. Anderson going deep. This one thrown too deep again. That's at least 4 that I've counted over through.
Yeah, well, Torrey Cox not fooled at all. They were trying to stop and go to try and get one over the Cox and to get one over the top of Torrey Cox, and he says,
He admitted he made the mistake with Newsom's touchdown at the beginning of the game, said it won't happen again. Wasn't going to get beat over the top here, but you guys are right. Anderson really struggling throwing that deep ball.
Well, actually, I made the mistake because he did technically get him down when he got that elbow on the ground. And yet he should have wrapped him up and left no doubt.
third and seven. Each team one timeout. Quarterback draw, fooling absolutely no one, certainly not Claude Harris.
And now, guys, the punt's coming up. You're at the one-yard line. That punter, normally 15 yards deep, is only going to be about 11 yards deep.
Everybody watching football that doesn't coach thinks, now, the best thing to do right here is to rush the punter and get a block. The best thing to do is to hold them up because they're going to be all tightened down in there and get a nice return, maybe running in the end zone. And if not, get excellent field position and have a chance to at least get a field goal and tie this thing up before the half.
We agree, Bill. We absolutely agree on that.
Don't say that.
No.
That's scary.
I agree.
Don't say that.
Well, what is this, our 18th game, 19th?
It was bound to happen.
All right, forget it. Go for the block.
We agreed on something way back about the third game.
Yeah.
But it's boring to agree all the time.
If they block it here, I wanted them to go for the block all along.
They're not going to do it.
And make sure that punter's foot doesn't step on that back line. You see, about a foot in front of it. Flag down. Not much of a kick at all. Robinson at the 37. Down at the 32. But a marker back in the end zone. Well, when it's that quick, Bill, a lot of time, is it holding when it's going to...
Procedure.
Yeah, well, I'm 0 for 2. I'm not going to try anymore.
I think they'll decline and take the football where they've got it because they're going to like the field
formation.
Position.
Offense, the penalty is declined. Pittsburgh's ball, first down.
Because they're already in field goal range, and if they'll be careful and work it down, if they can get some kind of short completion, maybe run the ball a time or two.
They have
might
time.
Get down there, but they're one out of five on third down, one out of six on third down conversion attempts here. Not good at all. And this is the first ranked third down defensive team in America for Oregon State over there in the black shirt.
Motion from Fitzgerald. Rutherford. Time to deliver and caught at the 21-yard line by Slade.
Wow.
Up for a first out if they mark him there. He backed up to the 22.
And we'll see how much they give him. It is a first, I think. Calvin Carlisle quickly on the tackle.
Shockingly, Oregon State in a two-deep zone defense there.
And not quite a first, as it turns out. So the ball spiked with 43 seconds. And it'll be third and a foot.
So now you got third down here, so you got to get the first. Is this a running play, Bill, and then you get to the line quick and kill it and start a second down, really?
Well, I think Rutherford is sick with himself right now because I think he thought it was a first down.
Yeah.
He didn't pay attention long enough, and he went ahead and spiked the ball and made it third down rather than second.
There should be plenty of time from this close. It's a 23.
He'll give to Myrie.
He has the second effort. He does have the first at the 20.
Now they'll get up. Now they'll kill it. No, start it off from second down.
38 seconds as they move the chain. And there's the spike. So second down from the 19 coming. 35 seconds.
Now, here's the thing. You take that shot because they've been in position before. In games, we've talked about the close losses where Rutherford has thrown that ball in the end zone and gotten the turnover.
Let me say two words to you. Larry Fitzgerald.
Yep.
If he's on your side, you put it up in the end zone. That's my opinion. That's what Walt needs to do right now. Give him a chance.
He's in the slot.
And motion again as Rutherford fires over the middle, incomplete.
It's a zone.
Intended for Slade, broken up by Houston.
Well, we don't have time to do replays because they're at the line of scrimmage. No huddle here. But what Oregon State's doing is very wise. They've broken their scheme completely and changed to a two-deep zone. They're not going to let Larry Fitzgerald run a fade pattern into the end zone without having two men on. They're not going
to
allow it.
That means somebody else is going to have to be the go-to guy if they're going to take that away. Again, we'll see where Fitzgerald lines up. Where's Chris Wilson been this half?
Yeah.
Fitzgerald in the slot again.
Still zone.
Wilson stays in the block.
Rutherford is sacked back at the 30 with 25 seconds, and they will race that duel in the field goal unit off.
Bill Swancutt had 10 sacks this year. Now he's got 11.
They've got time. 44-yard try coming up. 10 seconds and counting. Snap at 7 seconds. And the kick by Abdul, absolutely perfect. As time runs out in the first half, the true freshman ties it at 10. So they survive the sack of Rutherford by Swancutt and head to the locker room even.
Abdul now 11 out of his last 13. That's one heck of a true freshman.
What a great kick.
Oh, and you go in the locker room with such a good feeling. You manage to get it down the field and get something done, even though you can't make the first down against this defense on third down. This is a heck of a football game.
Pretty much what we thought, probably what Dennis Erickson expected, Dave Ryan.
Coach Erickson, an electrifying start for each team in the beginning of this game, then quite a bit of action at the end of the first half. Does the pace of the football game in the first 30 minutes work into your favor for the second half, you think?
Well, it's hard to tell. We've had some opportunities, and they haven't taken advantage of them like we need to. We need to get points on the board. We've been moving it fairly consistently, and they're playing the run, and we've got to be able to throw that play-action pass and hit it a few times. If we can do that, then we've got a chance. But they're playing well, and we're playing well, and that was a big play for them.
What's the theme of your message to your guys at halftime here?
Well, just keep hanging in there. We got to make plays. We got to be able to run the football a little bit better, and defensively, just keep doing what we're doing.
Third bowl game at Oregon State for Dennis Erickson. Going for win number two, Dave.
And so far, 10-10, Oregon State and Pittsburgh in the Inside Bowl at Bank One Ballpark in Phoenix. From Arizona, back to the studio, Chris Fowler.
Hi, Dave. Thanks for two spectacular touchdowns. One of them on a blown call. A couple of field goals.
Okay.
Well, it was a blown
You're
call
right.
with the elbow was down. Right? We read that rule. Mo Davenport read in that rule. Brad Edwards looked it up. 10-10 at halftime. What do you think?
Well, I've kind of been impressed with Derek Anderson. I mean, Pittsburgh is coming after Mark with a lot of pressure, and he's standing in there. And Bill Curry mentioned it in the telecast. They're playing man-to-man. At some point, you get the feeling if you just make one guy miss, it could be a huge play for Oregon State.
I'm surprised at Walt Harris. How come he's not throwing the ball deep to Larry Fitzgerald even more? The short patterns, I don't like that. He's been throwing the ball to other receivers. Get the ball to your best player on the football field. But I'm more impressed with Walt Harris' special teams. It's so difficult to get that field goal team on the field, everyone set up, to get the snap down, the kickoff, 47 yards, make it good. That's a very good job by the special
teams. A couple of very solid kickers and a good second half coming up. At the Dodge halftime report, we'll take you back to Motown. Interesting developments as Boston College, well, some may have questioned their motivation, but the Eagles came out and made a big, loud statement. I like the head.
Big Monday, presented by Bud Light, returns January 6th on ESPN.
You want 800-397 credit.
Click the call now.
I chose the colors, I chose the options, I got the car I wanted, and the payments I could afford.
Buy a car from your home.
The service is free.
And there's no commitment. Log on and apply. Or make the call now. 800-397 credit.
I was having trouble getting approved for an auto loan because of a discharge bankruptcy, so I made the call over my Touchstone phone, and it was easy.
Log on and apply.
Or make the call now.
1-800-397 credit.
Will they hook up, break up, fall in love? Will she save her family? Will he save the world? Will you look over your shoulder or sleep with a light on? Will your palms get sweaty? Will your heart begin to race? Will he look into your eyes and say,
I'm a black man!
What's going to happen? The Movie Channel. The stuff movies are made of.
This halftime report is presented by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
Well, two of the higher-ranked defenses to play in bowl week so far. We got a 10-10 halftime score, the Panthers and the Beavers. Welcome back to our Dodge halftime report. earlier tonight, Motor City, the Mid-American Conference with Toledo, brought a six-game winning streak into the bowl game. They're playing just about an hour from their campus in Motor City. They had most of the fans there. It seemed like a logical thing that Toledo might be the more motivated team against the Boston College team. Well, we weren't sure. So here's a little flashback about 4:35 Bristol time today.
You know, I think when you look at this game, the bottom line is this. In my opinion, Toledo has the better athletes. I mean, people might be surprised at that, but I think they have better overall talent, better speed than does Boston College.
Cut the inferior athletes of BC came out and played a pretty good game. There's Brian St. Pierre, the senior quarterback in his final game. He's going to look for Grant Adams. This is like playing against air. There's just no defense for the Rockets.
7-on-7 drill.
14-0 at that point. It was 14-3 in the second quarter. St. Pierre to Joel Hazard. Watch him weave through the secondary.
This is pretty much the story all day. I mean, it was Brian St. Pierre hitting wide open wide receivers, just running free. You know, apparently they had a little talent on that team.
Yeah, four possessions, four touchdowns. Here's the fifth possession. Once again, he goes to Adams in the slot. 40-yard touchdown. Five different Eagles scored in the first half. It was 42-18. I think he's got a little chippy here. Watch 68 for Toledo there. Oh, Plum.
Right, left, oh, right, left.
Unnecessary. Unnecessary. And 79 gets into the action, knocking guys down. They had a late hit on St. Pierre out of bounds right here. And the Tom O'Brien's team wasn't about to stop playing. They kept after it in the second half. And St. Pierre, in his final game of his college career, has a career high 342, 25 of 35, and three touchdowns. It's BC's first nine-win season since 1993. That was the year they beat Notre Dame and spoiled the Irish National Championship hopes in South Bend. And a nice way, I think, for the Eagles seniors to go out. They began their career as freshmen, getting humiliated in the Inside Bowl by Colorado. They turned the tables on Toledo tonight.
Sometimes as an analyst, you do your best to look at the game, look at the statistics, look at where they come from conferences, look at which team might be happy to be there and which isn't. Sometimes just frankly wrong. And I think what happened, Mark, here was a situation where I looked at this game and saw a team that had been kind of up and down, and I just wasn't right about this game, and I'm happy to say I was wrong about this game.
You're just coming with the love today. You wish me a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. You admit you're wrong. You feeling okay?
I was wrong. I've learned. Being married 7 years, it's okay to say you're wrong.
Okay, I was very impressed by Boston College, the way they played today. I think they played a perfect game this afternoon, particularly in the first half. They didn't miss a beat in the first half offensively, throwing the ball, Brian St. Pierre, running the football. They rushed for close to 150 yards in this football game. But this is one of those typical games you could tell that one team was very prepared. That was Boston College. They had their jaw set. They came out from play one, and they took it right to Toledo. And Toledo came in. Now, I thought they were a little lackadaisical, to tell you the truth. You know, I said at the beginning, you know, Tom Anstice, he's joking around with everybody before the game. I thought that was a good thing. I was with Trev. I thought that, you know, they play relaxed, but Boston College just put the hammer down.
I think they were overwhelmed. I think they played hard. Toledo did not show up. They were just overwhelmed.
Don't beat yourself up, big guy. Yeah. Nobody really here saw this coming, to be fair.
But the thing is, those superior athletes, they got to learn how to tackle.
Well, I should be better.
Coming up, we'll get a chance to say who's superior, K-State or Arizona State.
I get this one right.
In the first half, look at the catch by Larry Fitzgerald. Oh. Panthers and Beavers tied at 10. We're coming back.
Check it out.
In the all-new Ram Heavy Duty. Ram Heavy Duty. Enough muscle to grab Motor Trend's 2003 Truck of the Year Award.
Early in the morning when I wake up, I think, have I dreamt this whole thing? I get up and realize that JetBlue is serving tens of thousands of people on a daily basis.
We started 16 years ago with two people in one room. Our objective was to become the leading advertising and marketing services company in the world.
Growing up in the Detroit area, washing cars for $1.75 an hour was a great way to learn business from the ground up. Sun Microsystems is the best provider of network equipment for the world.
What I love about building a company is changing what's possible
and trying to do something that has never been done before.
The way you succeed is by having a very clear vision and then executing that.
The day we went public was a huge birth of a new idea and a new company.
We knew we had to be a NASDAQ-listed company.
What NASDAQ gives you is a global name.
It gives us a platform, a stage on which to operate in every country of the world. WPP,
JetBlue,
Sun Microsystems, listed on NASDAQ.
There is a start. There is a finish.
And in the journey between, there are dreams. The NCAA Hall of Champions keeps these dreams alive for you. More than a museum, the NCAA Hall of Champions takes you on an interactive journey. Relive some of the most inspirational moments in collegiate sports history and walk in the steps of a student athlete. At the NCAA Hall of Champions, you'll find something for every fan. Discover what it means to be a champion. The journey begins inside.
Angered by the sacrificial rituals of tribal priests, the Aztec god Quetzalcoatl turned the Sonoran Desert into a place that would forever challenge man. Just ask anyone who has played here.
It does make you want to take the clubs to Phoenix. We have so many meetings out there, I'm not going to get a chance.
Yeah.
Not that you guys are
the ball goes further
sad about that.
I like that.
I'll never know. Welcome back to the Dodge Halftime Report. Bowl week continues tomorrow. One of our three games, the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl. Now, back in 89, Kansas State took on Arizona State, a 31-zip blanking of the Wildcats. But that was Bill Snyder's very first game with the Wildcats, and a lot has changed with that program. Wildcats, the biggest favorite of bowl season against Arizona State. But the last four Holiday Bowls decided by a total of 16 points, and the Holiday Bowl is responsible for some wild games. Two of the seven highest scoring bowl games in bowl history. Here's Mike Tirico, Kirk Herbstreit with the preview.
Individual performances and terrific teams come through San Diego. As we hit the 25th anniversary of the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl, good chance to remind you why this game has become so special. Close games, no bowl game year in, year out, is tighter than the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl. And then the scoring gets it night in, night out, year in, year out. High scoring offenses, whether it's the WAC, or this year the Pac-10 and the Big 12. And you always get the great weather out here, so I'm going to have to put away your sunglasses for a second. Talk about the offense that could be lighting up the scoreboard in Qualcomm Stadium.
Well, it's always, you talk about the Holiday Bowl, you're right, you always talk about points. Let's start with Kansas State and start with their quarterback, L. Roberson. Continue to improve throughout the year. I think he finished the year as maybe the most athletic quarterback in all of college football. He can also hurt your throwing. The thing to remember about this offense is it has good balance. He can also hand the ball off to Darren Sproles, put low center of gravity. And I think it's a back to remember next year in all of college football. Now, Arizona State's probably their best chance to remain competitive in this game is to score points with Kansas State. It means Andrew Walter, their quarterback's going to have to get the ball downfield to Sean McDonald, who finished the year as one of the best wide receivers in all of college football. We met earlier today with Terrence Newman, one of the best defensive backs in the country. And he said, all this talk about a high-scoring game, don't they realize we got the best defense in the country?
Yeah.
We'll see. That's all he had to say.
He's one of the main reasons why Terrence Newman won the Jim Thorpe Award. It goes to the best DB in the country, but he's also a terrific kick returner as well. He's dynamic. There's a dynamic guy on the Arizona State defensive side. We speak of Terrell Suggs, who led the country in sacks, was the top lineman and the top defensive player in the award show this year.
All right, Mike, thank you, and we'll see if Kansas State shows up motivated, because you never know what you're going to get when they show up in a bowl game. But there are some pretty ugly numbers on the Arizona State side. That's why they're a big underdog. 25 touchdown passes allowed in the last 10 games. They better create some pressure with that guy Suggs.
Well, they're going to have to, and Mike and Kirk touched on Terrell Suggs, but the way that he can get after the passer, I want to take a couple of shots at him going after the quarterback. 22 sacks this year, 42 sacks in his career. Here, they try to cut him, they get around him, he gets to Carson Palmer, throws him down anyway against Arizona, just runs over the blocker and gets to the quarterback and sacks him again against USC. This is what makes a great pass rush is a dogged pursuit, even when the quarterback's already gotten rid of the ball, Trev. He had 22 sacks this year, and I think he won a lot of awards this year, but he didn't win one award that you won, the Buckets Award. You had 18 sacks this year.
Well, that's because I really wasn't a linebacker. I was a defensive end. That's another story. But, you know, in bowls, so many times we get to see great individual matchups. They mentioned it earlier, but Terrence Newman versus Sean McDonald, I think, will be a fabulous matchup in this game. You see Terrence Newman here. Hey, he's just a great cover guy. He's got great size here against Texas. You see him leap up to make the interception. Also great in special teams. Here's a punt return. He's got great speed, great vision. Obviously, he's going to be a key in this game. But I think if Arizona State's going to have a chance in this, you can't just sit there with Andrew Walter and throw the football. Their last game against Arizona, Mike Williams had 162 yards rushing. I'm going to get this one right. Listen, Kansas State will blow out Arizona State.
I think for Arizona State, if they have any chance, they got to win the turnover battle in a big way. You realize you go back 54 games, Arizona State, when they're winning or breaking even in turnovers, 30-1. That's incredible. When they don't win the turnover battle and they lose it, they are 3-20. That's a
and
remarkable.
If they're not balanced, you get pressure. They turn to, you know, yeah,
right,
exactly.
I think there's a lot of, you know, reasons to think the K-State's going to blow them out, but we'll see. It seems crazy things happen on bowl week. 10-10 at the break. We'll be back.
Powerful line of trucks on Earth. Ram Heavy Duty. Enough muscle to grab Motor Trend's 2003 Truck of the Year award.
All around the world, Siemens helps companies prosper by providing them with systems and controls that assure quality, regardless of quantity. Whatever the product, wherever consumers consume, we want to help them savor life better.
Where will you find OSU? An experimental forest conducting long-term ecological research. Over rivers, engineering ways to repair and replace bridges. With children who have disabilities working on their aquatic skills. In space, studying recycling methods at zero gravity. Oregon State University. You'll find us working in ways that are out of this world.
You've spent the entire month making everyone else happy. Now it's payback time. Announcing the ATA It's All About You sale. Take advantage of low sale fares from $55 to $89 to all our continental U.S. destinations. And do the things you want to do. Better hurry, this sale ends January 13th. Complete travel by April 30th. Earn free travel with our new anniversary travel awards promotion. Log on to ATA.com for details. ATA, an honestly different airline.
Whoa!
We're leaving in 5 minutes, guys.
The C240 sedan now with 4MATIC all-wheel drive. Disappointing kids everywhere.
This halftime report presented by Dodge. Brought to you in part by 1010-220. Dial it and all calls up to 20 minutes are 99 cents.
I said, Buckeyes, usually buttoned down in business life and showing up with some timely headgear stuff.
Did you bowl super that hat?
I'm not a fan of the hat. Not a fan of the hat, but they were free. But first to arrive, Miami players begin trickling in separately, of course, at Tocitos Fiesta Bowl on January 3rd. The mainstay Independence Bowl up next to a weird spot, Shreveport, for Nebraska to be at 7-6 coming off a two-game slide, and not many of the Husker faithful will follow them down there. I mean,
they've decided that it looks a lot like Omaha, so they're staying in Omaha.
But still down in Shreveport, Jeff Hollinger and Todd Christensen with the preview.
As home to most of America's B-52s, Barksdale Air Force Base has been a vital participant in Operation Enduring Freedom. Bombers have made the prevailing airstrikes in Afghanistan. I know many of the men and women here are great football fans. They're excited about the mainstay Independence Bowl, and I'm sure they won't mind if we make a little bit of an air analogy concerning Eli Manning.
It's certainly apt. With the leading rusher a scant 350 yards, the onus of the success of the offense falls squarely on the shoulders of number 10, and he has responded. Throwing for over 3,000 yards and 20 touchdowns. He needs to live with the specter of his older brother, and I think sometimes the expectations are unrealistic. But it's my feeling that Eli Manning has had a fantastic campaign in 2002.
Meanwhile, some quarterbacks are more old school, as menacing on the ground as they are in the air. Nebraska's Jamal Lord comes immediately to mind.
Certainly a difficult year for Nebraska. The lone spot had to be the 1,329 yards put up by Jamal Lord. And when you think of the number of great quarterbacks that they have had here, Tommy Frazier, Turner Gill, Scott Frost,
And, of course, even last year's Heisman Trophy winner, Eric Crouch. To think that that's the most rushing yards by any quarterback in the history of Cornhusker football, very impressive.
Let's go back 30 years ago. How about Jerry Tackey?
Not quite the same runner, but he did get him a national title.
All right, two schools that have never met on a football field, Ole Miss and Nebraska. They are tradition-rich. It's the mainstay Independence Bowl from Shreveport, Louisiana.
All right, Jeff, thank you. That is the middle game in tomorrow's triple-header. Trevor's going to track down the rumor that Eli Manning is dating Brittany. We're getting to the bottom.
That's what I've heard. Ravi told me
that's
on the
word. Yes, the entertainment beat.
He's on ET tonight.
All right. Yeah. We'll be back.
Did you, madam, proceed to wear this shirt, knowing full well that your neighbor had already received this title?
Well.
Indeed. You're a witness.
Your Honor, I have only one thing to present in defense of my client, the Dodge Caravan.
Proving once again, Dodge Caravan is the choice of great moms everywhere.
I told you we should have settled.
Grab Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it.
This thing you carry with you everywhere. This thing you obsess about and face ridicule for. This thing you're not sure that you'll ever be able to quit may have just met its match. Introducing the new Commit Lozenge, an FDA-approved medicine that has the power to help fight your addiction. Its medicine keeps working even after the lozenge is gone. You use less and less until you use none. Imagine if this thing were just a thing. The new Commit Lozenge. Real power. Real help.
They call this art?
I'll tell you what I call it, brother.
It symbolizes my frustration committing to a phone plan I don't always need.
You should be down at 1010-220, little dude.
Yeah, it's a great phone service with no monthly commitment.
With 1010-220, I'll call up to 20 minutes for 99 cents.
It's cheap, whether you use it a little or a lot.
And it's a great deal.
Now, this speaks to me.
It says cheap.
Dial 1010-220.
Brother!
I'm a junior at the University of Pittsburgh, majoring in environmental studies and political science. I chose Pitt because I wanted an academic challenge. Throughout Pitt, there are many nationally ranked programs, from the writing program to medicine to philosophy. So many talented students are here. More Marshall and Rhodes scholars have come out of Pitt in the last 15 years than any other college in Pennsylvania. The opportunities here are limitless. Coming to Pitt was the best decision I ever made.
Welcome back to ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
On a clear, chilly night, with the roof open, Bank One Ballpark to sight for the Inside Bowl, 10-10, Pittsburgh and Oregon State. All right, now let's send it down below to Dave Ryan.
Well, Dave, thanks a lot. This game is being billed as college football like you've never seen it before. One highlight for the fans here at the Inside Bowl at the Bob. They're able to keep all footballs that are kicked into the stands. Unfortunately for one fan, he took it one step too far. This is the Abdul field goal for Pittsburgh to end the first half. And at the bottom of your screen, you're going to see Greg Stofak of Denver, Colorado, make an unbelievable catch. However, we're in a baseball stadium. He goes right into the dugout, which would be down the first base line. Landed on the right side of his head, and he hurt his wrist badly. He's been immobilized, as you can see, and taken off for precautionary measures. They think he's going to be okay. Got full movement in all extremities. And the good news is, guys, he hang on. Ball was able to hold on to it, and he's got the football for a souvenir.
Well, that's the very least they can do for him.
That's a great job.
I don't think I would want that football that bad.
Well,
he caught that thing like Larry Fitzgerald.
That was an excellent catch, and we're glad it sounds like he's going to be all right.
But sure hope he's okay.
Really is kind of unique here. The ball goes into the stands. The fans catch it. Normally, they have to throw it back. Tonight, they get to keep it.
But the guy dove into.
Yeah. I don't think he meant to. I don't think he really meant to.
You know, big league catchers know where the dugout is. He didn't have a chance to study that.
I think he had the proper cleats on.
Underway with the second half kickoff. Abdul. Brandon Kennedy. Out to the 30. And Oregon State going from there in a 10-10 game. And we go back to the touchdown they scored where Newsom should have been called down when the elbow hit at midfield. That's gone now. What can they do to continue the momentum, talking about Pittsburgh, that they got by Abdul's late field goal?
Well, what they got to do is continue to play great defense. They've been able to bottle up Steven Jackson. He's got 15 carries for 33 yards. I mean, that's just really uncharacteristic for him.
Yeah, and they do need to get Jackson on the goal a little bit. As Dennis Erickson told Dave Ryan before half, then you can work into play action pass, something they have not been able to do at all.
Jackson has to reverse field, a flag down. Jackson in a foot race. Tez Morris with an angle and catches him at the 10, but the marker came right where Jackson reversed field, and it will come back holding Oregon State.
There's going to be no one as disappointed as Jackson, who had to run that whole way.
59 yards worth.
That was a beautiful run. Once again, he was bottled up, and for the first time tonight, Pittsburgh's defense made a contain error, let him bounce it and get to the outside on the other side, and we saw the speed that Dennis Erickson told us about, and he outran almost everybody.
During the run, holding offense. 10 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
We'll see if we can pick up who is the guilty party here.
Starts to the right.
It's 84 again. He's been holding all night long.
Right here. Tim Hewitt
should have been called about 10 or 12 other times, so sooner or later that gets you. You've got to keep those hands in and keep them between the shoulder pads, but a great run by Jackson, who shows the kind of speed and versatility he has.
That, in effect, is a 69-yard penalty back to the 21. Anderson's throw is caught on a slide by Newsom. Out to the 33. An ESPN game track early in the third quarter. Larry Fitzgerald, let's watch it again. Takes off at the 5, makes the catch to the end zone, 7-0 Pittsburgh at that point. Jackson averaging 138-33 so far tonight, and replaced by Dwight Wright after that 59-yarder call back. Wright has the same luck Jackson has. Hit by Gerald Hayes behind the line of scrimmage.
Same guy. And Gerald's getting the job that he really needs from his men up front. 96, Vince Petunas, Dan Stevens, number 94. Those defensive tackles are doing a great job, Mike.
Boy,
they're giving him a place to shoot the gap. He's not being blocked. He's taking hits behind the line of scrimmage.
The coaches were saying this D-line for Pittsburgh, they almost use them like an offensive line at times to block the offensive line of Oregon State to keep them off of Moore and of Hayes to make the tackle. But they've been getting their fair share of plays as well, that D-line.
Jackson still gets the breather. Wright stays in. Anderson has Ewers across the middle for the first down. He drags Sean Robinson out to the 44. Gain of 14 for the junior from Eugene. Numbers at the half, you see no turnovers.
How odd is that, Bill, for all the time off you have from the last game of the season until the bowl game and the practice and his coaches, you give them time off to have that right there?
Well, I think that's a tribute to the coaches and the players' concentration, because normally you expect to have a couple of turnovers in the first half of your bowl game.
Oregon State, the number one rushing team in the Pac-10, averaging 160 on the ground, virtually no running game tonight. Dropped by Cole Clayson across midfield. Jackson back in for this set of downs. It'll be second and 10.
And you said it, Bill. This is what Pittsburgh's plan is. Take Steven Jackson out of the game. Force Derek Anderson, that man right there, to beat him. Pittsburgh thinks if it's in Anderson's hands, that they have the advantage. The Panthers have the advantage. That's their thought.
Dennis Erickson's thought to counter that is that we're going to keep running and we're going to make some yards, and then we're going to throw the play action off the run, and we've got to connect on some of those deep play action throws.
Jackson will toss it right back to Anderson on the flea flicker. He will throw it away, intercepted by Tez Morris. Marker down, though. Morris returns to the 23-yard line.
Wow.
An ill-fated flea flicker returned 35 yards by the redshirt freshman from Hamilton, Ohio. They will decline and keep the ball.
And it was Tim Hewitt on the hold again, number 84. Simply has a bad habit of grabbing cloth. And I don't know if the coaches talked to the officials at the half, Mike, but they're on to him now.
They certainly are. And Anderson, look at the pressure coming late on Anderson as he gets the pitch. He can't get enough into this throw. He can't step into it at all because Brian Beneke is getting into his face there. So he has no muster on that ball at all. So far underthrown. Very easy for Morris to step in front of that ball.
Tez getting a congratulation for setting Pittsburgh up first out of the 23. And Rutherford ready to go deep. There's Fitzgerald. He had to go to the deck to make the catch at the one. And first and goal from there could easily have been a touchdown if it's thrown a little bit higher.
Now this is beautiful offensive thinking by J.D. Brookhard. Nice job putting him in motion. He comes across. It is a zone. They were in that too deep at the dig pattern. Great job in converting on the touch, on the throw, and it should have been a touchdown. I knew I could get that out. Should have been a touchdown with a better throw.
High and two tight ends. And Rutherford will keep, step in, touchdown. Pittsburgh back in front.
Offside, defense, penalty is declined. Touchdown.
Oregon State offside, touchdown.
This is Pittsburgh taking advantage of Oregon State coming out of their normal defensive game plan. They love to play that man coverage. They love to jam at the line of scrimmage. What they're doing with Larry Fitzgerald, he goes in the slot. He's the motion man. He's always moving. And they're playing zone back there a few times, and that time they got caught again. Fitzgerald makes the big catch, sets up the touchdown.
Abdul, who hammered the field goal at the end of the first half, to tie it. Now make it the Panthers again by seven. Nothing new for them. Their last four games all decided by 7 points. Half of a one bowl week. From the Bob in Phoenix, sees Rod Rutherford keep for the go-ahead score for the Pittsburgh Panthers.
This is Gladys. Gladys works for a big computer reseller. When she's done selling, this is what you're left with. Jennifer works at Insight. She helps you find the products you need at prices you like from an inventory of over 100,000 products. Experts like Jack, Ann, and Jim design, configure, and deliver even the most complex IT solutions. From a single notebook to enterprise networks, Insight delivers more products, expertise, and value, even financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
You should change before we pick up the girls.
Okay.
Chevy Avalanche. Changes from a pickup to an SUV.
What are you doing?
Avalanche like a rock.
We all lead such busy lives. But there is a place where redwoods stand tall and time flows slowly. Redwood Creek, where the tradition of slowing down and taking time has never been forgotten. An unhurried approach to winemaking that leads to a richer, more full-bodied taste. Redwood Creek, because good things take time.
There is a start. There is a finish. And in the journey between, there are dreams. The NCAA Hall of Champions keeps these dreams alive for you. More than a museum, the NCAA Hall of Champions takes you on an interactive journey. Relive some of the most inspirational moments in collegiate sports history and walk in the steps of a student athlete. At the NCAA Hall of Champions, you'll find something for every fan. Discover what it means to be a champion. The journey begins inside.
Rod Rutherford, the quarterback, leads Pittsburgh in rushing touchdowns. He just scored his sixth of the year. And it was after Derek Anderson's interception, the first turnover of the game, immediately turns into seven for the Panthers in the 17-10 lead.
So much for the no turnover talk we just had, huh?
That ended immediately on the flea flicker. Abdul kicking down to the 6-yard line. Cadenese on the return again. Hit at the 23-yard line. William Ferguson. Pittsburgh, looking back, had this 2-point try go around. They lost by two to Texas A&M. They dominated Notre Dame every way you could statistically. Couldn't get enough points.
with plenty of opportunities, and they lost by 8. That was their worst loss of the season. Then they're throwing to the end zone at the end of the game in the Orange Bowl, overthrown to Yogi Roth, and they lose that one by 7. They then give up this late big play to West Virginia and lose the backyard brawl by 7. 4 straight 7-point results they lost the last 2. Anderson Chase throwing it for Ewitt and broken up by Lewis Moore. So this Pittsburgh team, again, is that close. Everybody likes to go back and say, if this, what if that? But they really have one play in each of their 4 losses that kept them from 12-0.
And Walt Harris has said, you know what, we're not about the moral victories. They're saying, guys, we were close, good job. It's like, no, we've got to make that extra play. We've got to not fumble that ball. We've got to stop that big play. We've got to get that win. There at that point, rather quickly, he has turned this program around.
Well, now they have made the most big play. Second down catch, Kenny Farley, maybe 5 yards, and immediately hit by Gerald Hayes.
And what happens when you have this kind of success and you're clearly in control of the program is that other schools come calling, and so then the rival recruiters jump on Walt Harris's bandwagon gladly, saying, yep, he's going to get another job, so you certainly don't want to go play for him. But he has put all those rumors to rest by confronting them directly and saying, look, I'm going to be here. The players are responding. Both these teams playing hard.
We said the outset tonight, a great matchup, and the coaching matchup may be right at the top. Off the hands of Farley. And after the score, the Panther defense turns in a 3-and-out.
And lastly, Bill, to put a period on this, you talk about Walt Harris and the talk. How about the assistant coaches? Paul Rose, the defensive coordinator, was up for the East Carolina job. You become successful, and all of a sudden, other teams are after your assistants to become head coaches, so you have that to contend with as well.
Carl Toby kicking to Robinson at the 32. 5-yard return.
Well, that's a good problem.
Yeah.
If
somebody's not coming after your assistants, then you're not having much success. Pittsburgh having some success here in the third quarter. They've broken a 10-10 tie for half thanks to the Anderson pick.
This is how most computer products arrive at your business. And this is what's left after the box is unpacked. At Insight, account executives help you find the products you need at the best prices. Hundreds of certified technicians and engineers design, configure, test, and install your IT equipment. Whether you're buying for a home office or one of the Fortune 1000, you get the best combination of product, expertise, and price. Right down to financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
There's a place that I travel when I want to roam, and nobody knows it but me. The roads don't go there, and the signs stay home, and nobody knows it but me. It's far, far away, and way, way afar. It's over the moon and the sea. And wherever you're going, that's wherever you are. And nobody knows it but me. Chevy Tahoe, like a rock.
Beavers that have issues to discuss. Derek Anderson and Steven Jackson, either one having their best game. Our Coors Light storyline, Larry Fitzgerald up to 5 catches, 77 yards, and the first touchdown. Only 33 yards on 15 carries for Steven Jackson, the leading rusher in the Pac-10. Newsom with the 65-yard catch and run over 100 yards on his five catches. Hey, look at that pile moving forward.
Wow.
They're not booing, they're looing.
Lusaka Polite.
Lusaka Polite is a load. He's a big fullback, a terrific blocker, and pretty darn good runner. This was impolite on his part.
Look at this. Talk about it. You just keep the old leg moving. Great lesson here for the little ones watching. Look at the leg drive.
Nice job by Chad Reed, the center, too, number 64, and Rob Petitti, number 78, the left tackle. Good blocking up front.
Gain of seven. Back to Myrie. Close to the first down.
Close to midfield.
Yep, he got the first down.
Mike, we're starting to see the Pittsburgh line take control, it would appear.
And this is exactly what we saw against Virginia Tech. Again, Virginia Tech, when Pittsburgh played them, was number one against the run, giving up just 40 yards a game. Pittsburgh ran for 275 yards in the win, and this is exactly what we saw, Bill. You're right. Coming in the second half, the offensive line for Pittsburgh just started to really roll.
High formation on first and 10. Play fake. Rutherford for Slade. And incomplete. NBA season continues tomorrow night, ESPN2 at 7:30 Eastern. The pregame show NBA scoreboard at 8 Eastern. Ray Allen and the Milwaukee Bucks in the Meadowlands against Jason Kidd and the defending Eastern Conference champion New Jersey Nets. NBA Fridays on ESPN2 this week for the Bucks and the Nets. They gave the Boston Celtics.
Oh, the Nets are smoking, aren't they?
36-point Christmas present for a loss.
You like that deal? We'll talk about after the play, getting the tumble there and giving up.
I like Jason Kidd.
Oh, he's done.
Rutherford with a blitz. Gets the screen off to Myrie. Myrie carrying a tackler right near, but not quite to, the first down marker, Noah Happy.
Nice job by Noah Happy running it down, but you got to make the tackle a little quicker than that. Again, this is a screen setup. Wake up. Come on, a little time change. I know. A little yawn out of one.
Well, that was an all-out blitz, and if you can block the guy that's covering the back, then you got a chance to run that thing in the end zone if you get it off. And he got it off. Nice job by Rutherford. He just was very calm. And then the lineman turned and ran Myrie down. Otherwise, he'd still be running.
Chance for the Beaver defense to get off the field or the Panther drive to continue. That will be the case. On the sneak, Rutherford gets 2 yards out of it.
I know Oregon State's great in the third down situations, Bill, but third and about half a yard, you can do that. In the first half, Pittsburgh was just 1 of 7 on third down. It's easy to convert maybe when it's a half a yard.
Well, that's the kind you want. Yeah. Those third and nines are a little bit more problematic. The third and a half yard is nice, but there it is. I mean, this is a stunning number by Oregon State. Third down defense, 24.7% on the year.
Their last two games, they're about 3 of 26. Third down conversion. Forget about it in the fourth quarter all year. Rutherford all day. Behind deep for Slade, overthrown. We have had a ton of open receivers overthrown. Most of them by Anderson, but Rutherford does it here.
And to be able to throw the ball that deep, and that means the play has to develop, which means you have to have time. Look at that. Nobody near. Can't even see Rutherford. He's out of the picture. No linemen are near.
Matt Morgan, Brian Anderson, Chad Reed, Dan LeCart, Rob Petitti just moving those feet. Keeping those hands up. I think pass protecting is the second toughest thing in sports, second only to hitting a baseball. Very difficult to do that.
Panthers doing it very consistently tonight. Rutherford has very seldom felt any bit of pressure. Fitzgerald pulls away from Houston, gets a block from Marcus Furman, and they'll mark him out of bounds at the 24, a gain of 17.
Well, we see Mewson get beat on the touchdown. We see Mewson get beat on the in route to the 1 yard line by Fitzgerald. And here Mewson misses the tackles. We have a flag down. Again, Fitzgerald in motion. He's been in motion all night. Quick pass saying, we'll get it to our guy. We think he can shake your guy. It's exactly what Fitzgerald does. Getting the extra yard.
Pretty close to a late hit, too.
Yep.
They wave off the flag. First and 10, Pittsburgh, 24 of Oregon State. And Dennis Erickson already trailing by 7, 10-10 at the half. The Panthers have dominated the third quarter.
Sophisticated offense, finding the mismatch. That's what you're seeing.
One drop early. Since then, 5 catches, 89 yards. One touchdown, one near touchdown. Last possession got him down to the 1. Myrie with a toss sweep. Got away from Swancutt, but then plenty of black jerseys arrived to help corral Myrie for a loss.
Now, Swancutt ran him down from behind because he did not have contain responsibility on the backside, but I would not be surprised to see Pittsburgh come back with some kind of reverse or naked because Swancutt just took off down the line of scrimmage, and normally the defensive end on the backside has responsibility for anything coming back, reverse responsibility.
Exploratory study. That's where you look for stuff. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there you go. I think they call that undecided.
Right. Okay.
Loss of 5. Rutherford in the grasp of Happy and down at the 34. Noah Happy, former walk-on from Simi Valley, California. Yeah.
Happy takes care of Matt Morgan, who's trying to block him. Again, not a big guy, 6'3", about 200, or 6'5", I should say, about 240. Nice move on the inside. That's his 4th sack of the year.
Junior making his 24th straight start tonight. As big a play as Oregon State has had. They force a 3rd and 20 empty backfield, 5 wide. Rutherford quarterback draw, and that goes nowhere.
Well, Happy's really happy. Yeah.
Happy's a versatile guy. He's a long snapper for punts. Obviously a tough guy picking up the pace here and really pretty much knocked him out of field goal range. They're going to have to punt the ball.
Ooh. Starts up, out wide, comes underneath. This is what Dennis Erickson does. He was a recruited linebacker to D-line. He recruits safeties and makes them linebackers. That's how Dennis Erickson gets the great athletes, shift their position a little bit for him, and they just out-athlete the guy in front of them.
Flag is down. The punt by Lee is absolutely perfect. Cox finally downing it, they'll say, at the 3. But see what the flag is back at the line.
Probably a formation error by Pitt. Yep, that's the call. They'll make them kick it again.
Good call, Bill. I've missed the last 2. I'm not guessing anymore.
Big Ten officiating crew headed by
illegal
David Winfield.
Formation on the offense. 5 yards previous spot. Repeat 4 count.
Well, hard to hit 2 that good back-to-back. Andy Lee will try, though.
Lee has put 13 of them inside the 20 this year. He's had 11 touchbacks, so almost even there. So we'll see if he can drop it again.
Well, they officially set the ball over for a quick word. The first meeting ever between these two. The first time for Pittsburgh to play anybody from the Pac-10 in 7 years plus. Since the 1995 opener. Team that started 8-2 before losing to Miami and West Virginia, but they can win 9 for the first time in 20 years. Walt Harris has brought a long-awaited run of success to the University of Pittsburgh. Not too shabby. Lee down to the 1, and Cox got it again. Taps it back to the 5.
Cox is having a career special teams night. What a wonderful job. Again, he knows exactly where he is. That's the smart thing he's doing. He's along the end zone line, in this case the goal line. The ball does not break the plane in the judgment of the official. If that ball crossed the plane in college football, it would go out to the 20-yard line as a touchback. The official on the goal line, in his judgment, Cox got there soon enough.
Crank up Bobby McFerrin, why not? Don't worry, be happy. 17-10 Panthers.
College basketball on ESPN. Quicklane Tire and Auto Repair and all others is night and day. Only Quicklane is open all day and all night, 7 a.m. to midnight, which means Quicklane's factory trained technicians and state-of-the-art equipment are available to you day and night. Quicklane also offers free towing and free loaners. All work is guaranteed and all services are covered by this low price guarantee. Get an oil and filter change now for only $19.95. Quicklane, the difference is day and night. 1/2 mile north of I-55 on Route 83 in the Woodlawn Plaza next to Dunkin' Donuts.
If you live in the suburbs and want low city pricing, but you're afraid of high city taxes, Jacobs Twin Auto Plaza has a message for you. Your sales tax is based on where you live, not where you buy. And you won't find a selection like this anywhere else in Chicago. So if you live in the western suburbs, you're just minutes away from volume savings at Jacobs Twin Auto Plaza. Blocks east of Harlem on Grand Avenue.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2002 Insight Bowl, presented by Insight. Only Insight delivers the best combination of computer products, services, and price. Insight, whatever it takes. And in part by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Oregon State back up to its own five after more terrific special team play by Pittsburgh. Stephen Jackson standing 2 yards back of the end zone. As the lone back takes the handoff right at the goal line and run down by Hayes at the line of scrimmage again. At least a half dozen head-to-head Hayes versus Jackson collision.
Here we go back to the saving. Now, in the NFL, if your body is in the end zone like that, that is a touchback, but not in college. The player can be standing in the end zone if he wants, as long as the ball doesn't cross the plane of the end zone. Now, it did look like the ball was pretty close.
Yes, it did.
To breaking the plane there, but the body is allowed to be in the end zone as long as you knock the ball back out or the ball does not cross the end zone line.
The goal line. Average on first down, the last 11 first down snaps, 1 yard for Oregon State.
A roll and another overthrow, almost intercepted by Cox.
Intended for Newsom, who's got to be frustrated. He's had a big night, over 100 yards receiving. It could have been double that if not for the overthrows by Derek Anderson.
Yeah, and Cox is even more frustrated because that was an easy catch. There's an old adage about being a defensive back because you don't have good hands, and Cox would not like to hear that, but this is a catch you got to make. An overthrow, which is what Anderson's been doing all night, which is playing right into Pittsburgh's hands. Paul Rhodes, the fine defensive coordinator, has made an intelligent gamble that Anderson can't beat him with his arm. It's working, but Cox has got to come up with catches like that.
That's two interceptions for the year, and unanimous first team all Big East corner. Anderson from his end zone. That one's high, but not too high this time for Newsom, and he brings it in for a first down.
Wow. We talk about Fitzgerald getting up. Newsom doing the same thing. Sean Robinson on the coverage. Derek Anderson having the problem all night of overthrowing, but Newsom says, you know what, I'll just go up and get it.
Gain of 11. Got another year, has the Oregon State single season yardage and touchdown record. It is 12th of the year earlier tonight.
Jackson run down again by Gerald Hayes, the broken record for a loss of one. Down to Dave Ryan.
All right, Dave, thanks a lot. We talked about Derek Anderson, the Oregon State quarterback, and his huge feet. You guys mentioned it earlier. It turns out a size 16. Now, Nike in this particular version of the shoe only makes up to a 15, so a 17 size mole has got to be stretched to make it into a 16. But believe it or not, Derek does not have the largest feet on the team. That belongs to Brandon Scales. He is a redshirt freshman defensive end, size 18. Dave,
I think he could jump in one of those and float up the Pacific Coast back up to Oregon. Well, Anderson just playing big, 6'6", 235. Low snap. And incomplete. Caught by U.S. but out of bounds.
Now again, Oregon State in the situation of third and 10 or more. Here it's third, going to be third and 11. And this is a definite advantage to Pittsburgh. Now last time, this is Last series, Anderson was able to complete it to Newsom for the first down. Now he's faced with it again.
And Pittsburgh is throwing everything they've got at him. They're coming with six. They're coming with seven. They're blitzing like crazy. Anderson standing in there. It looks like a catch. It must have been ruled that he did not have control of the football.
Of possession of the ball, exactly. Four wides, third and 11. And again, over Newsom, who is frantically arguing that he was interfered with. He can't get any takers. I mean, last time it was that, guys, what'd they run? 11-yard route and got the first down? This time they try and go long.
Well, they got it. They know Derek Anderson can make the throw, and they're thinking sooner or later he's going to hit it, and that time it wasn't open.
Standing just outside the end zone is Tobin. They've not had a punt blocked all year. Former walk-on. And they get the Panthers to and whistle before the snap. Shante Spencer in particular drawn offside from the left end spot.
Pittsburgh was really messing with their protection scheme. They were walking a man in and out, back and forth, and causing the wide man to come in for protection purposes. And they got everybody rattled over there on the offensive side.
Fire to turn out. Defense in the narrow zone. 5 yards. Repeat fourth down.
Shante Spencer walking back and forth with another man rotating out to cover the wide receiver, but the outside man, and they end up messing themselves up. Here he goes again. Same thing. Forcing the man back in tight.
They came after Tobin. It's off of beauty. Nose down spiral. Robinson from the 35. Breaks the tackle. Cuts it back.
Supposed to happen, Bill, when you're going for the block. I mean, the whole punt team is down there covering the punt.
That's exactly right. But a great individual effort with a little help and a missed tackle. A missed tackle by Jameson, number 9, cornerback for Oregon State. Gave Shante Robinson all the room he needed, and he exploded down the sideline. After a very well-played special teams night.
He got hit harder.
65 yards for Sean Robinson. Senior from Warren, Ohio. Makes it 23-10, and now Abdul makes it 14. Pittsburgh over Oregon State. With a pair of third-quarter touchdowns, Sean Robinson breaking a tackle and then untouched from about midfield on.
This is Gladys. Gladys works for a big computer reseller. When she's done selling, this is what you're left with. Jennifer works at Insight. She helps you find the products you need at prices you like from an inventory of over 100,000 products. Experts like Jack, Ann, and Jim design, configure, and deliver even the most complex IT solutions. From a single notebook to enterprise networks, Insight delivers more products, expertise, and value, even financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
New Silverado is here. Still available with the 340 horse Vortec V8.
What are you waiting for?
Loan officer. I'm trying to get a home equity line.
I'm from eLoan. Unlike this bank, we'll get you a decision in minutes. Here.
I'm approved.
We'll even come to you to sign the papers, and you'll have your money as quick as 12 days. So you get your cash fast at a great rate. still want to wait for that loan officer?
Not anymore.
A bank shouldn't come between you and your money. That's why there's eLoan. Apply now at eLoan.com or call 1-800-ELOAN-22.
K-State's powerhouse offense looks to cool off the Sun Devils. Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl, Friday at 8 on ESPN.
Before tonight, Sean Robinson's longest punt return this year was 15 yards. This one goes 65. Well, here's the problem. Again, it's a block. They have all the Oregon State players. You got a fan out. Bill, what's it called?
Lane integrity.
Uh-huh. No lane integrity. They're stacked on each other. He's able to break it to the outside where all of a sudden he finds some help. That should not happen when the punt return team is trying to block the punt. All your guys are coming down there, but you've got to fan out.
Yeah, coaches like this stuff. Gets smashed in the face. Face mask gets knocked into his teeth. He's over there with a bloody mouth, but he's happy. Thanks, coach.
Pat at ease. Finally, driven out by William Ferguson. At the 30, and it continues way beyond the whistles down there. And finally, flag all over the place.
We have, by the way, now had four punt return touchdowns already in this bowl field. Looks like Gerald Hayes, who's led the way by being a great tackler tonight, took a shot down there at somebody. Very unlike him, because he's a poised young man and normally does all his work between the white lines. And Gerald, that's what you need to remember.
That senior's got to know that, Bill. You're absolutely right. Here he is right here. There's the shot.
Yep, that's what was called. Absolutely must maintain your poise.
Personal foul. The kick is in. 15 yards from the end of the run. First down.
Now, you have a great play, and you take a two-touchdown lead, and now you come back, and your defensive team leader is going to give him field position at the 45-yard line simply because he couldn't keep his poise. You can't pop the guy like that. You can't do any damage to him. Anyhow, he's got his helmet on.
Yep.
You don't even have your helmet. You need to put your helmet on if you're going to do that, Gerald, because somebody's going to hit you back, big man. You're a great football player, but that's a bad mistake.
Pop Chaz Scott in the face. First out from the 45. Wild high again. And he really hung Kittner out to get blasted by Shante Spencer. Now here's the situation here, and you're right, Bill. They gave him good field position on the bad penalty. But he have an Oregon State team down 14. Are they going to start to be taken out of that game plan? They have not been able to get a running game going. Dennis Erickson said at halftime, we're going to continue to try it. They have tried and been unsuccessful doing it. Anderson, 12 of 30. Two of his last 10 for only 16 yards. Robinson with the first ever punt return touchdown in a bowl for the Panthers. Fourth this year in the bowl season. Only one all of last bowl season. Anderson this time right on the number two of James Newsom. Best pass this half by far up to the 41.
Anderson's history is that he plays extremely well until he starts to get tattooed and hit, as he was by Southern Cal this year. Now he's taken some vicious hits tonight, and it's caused him to make some mistakes. Not just the deep balls that we've referred to, but throwing things up for grabs that have been intercepted, a couple of them dropped. And then he comes back and makes a throw like we just saw, and he shows that there's still life in his poise. Pittsburgh's going to keep coming at him, as they did here.
Jackson's going to keep looking in vain for the big holes he enjoyed most of the year. 5 yards, about the most the Pittsburgh defense has given him. And he's fighting for every yard of it. I mean, he is absolutely fighting for every yard of it. Give that D-line and linebacking crew so much credit for Pittsburgh and what they're doing.
Averages 5.5 yards per carry.
Tonight he's getting 2. 18 carries, 36 yards. And this Erickson expects about 100 more than that on a typical Steven Jackson night. Beinecke coming on a blitz. That one should have been caught by Kenny Farley right in his hand.
Don't forget our Capital One Bowl Week continues here on ESPN with a triple header tomorrow, starting with College Game Day's Bowl Special, presented by Outback at noon Eastern, 1 o'clock Southern Miss Oklahoma State in the 2002 Houston Bowl, 4:30 Eastern, Ole Miss Nebraska from Shreveport in the Mainstay Independence Bowl at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, Kansas State number 6 in the country, one of the hottest teams in the country, closing the regular season, try and keep it going against Arizona State in the 25th annual Pacific Life Holiday Bowl from San Diego. Third down and 6. Anderson again with a strike to Newsom, beating Teron Gray again for a first down, again at 13.
Coach, I like that call. Third and 6, you run that 8-9 yard in, get the first down, move to 6, start another series.
When we're done, Sports Center will wrap up the day. 2 minutes in the third quarter. Oregon State down 14. Working on the backup Pittsburgh corners this drive. Anderson, Newsom again at the 7. Working Shante Spencer and Teron Gray, 17 yards this time.
This is a marvelous talent Derek Anderson possesses, and his coach is so happy to work with, and he's coming back again and again. He's showing some courage here, setting his feet. Nice throw. Newsom makes a cut. Not particularly tight coverage by Shante Spencer there. Should have been right in his hip pocket.
Cox is back in, the starter at one quarter, but Spencer stays in. Not Robinson at the other, and it's first and goal, Beavers. Anderson sacked back at the 14.
Nice job of coverage that time by Pittsburgh.
That is the second sack tonight for Harriott.
Harriott ran him down because he had no place to go with the football. Back to the man coverage.
That's one of those, if he sees Harriott coming just a split second sooner, if he's out of the pocket, he'll get rid of the ball. It won't be intentional grounding outside the pocket. And it's not second and goal from the 14-yard line.
Anderson's a little scattered tonight, but Erickson says he can be as good as any quarterback I've coached. He's coached Heisman quarterback. That's that much of his potential. To the end zone, back to the overthrow. Too tall for Newsom. Almost intercepted.
For the first time tonight, we're seeing a true eight-man drop zone with a three-man rush. That pass broken up by number 31, Tyrone Gilyard. But you see the three people rushing now, eight people dropping. There is not much place to throw this football. Awful lot of white shirts all around the end zone. And the underneath stuff is easy to break up upon. And that's exactly what happens with Gilyard making the play. And you're not used to seeing that. It's a steady diet. It just looks like a lot of white shirts back there.
Third and goal, first time inside the 20 from the 14, and well incomplete. As Cox was much closer to that one than Newsom.
Well, they'll go for the 3 out of this, and again, this could have been more disastrous for Pittsburgh the way that Oregon State was driving, Bill, after the Gerald Hayes penalty, which gave Oregon State 15 extra yards.
Well, Hayes is out there leading his troops, his defensive troops. And to hold them to 3 points right here is very important for Pittsburgh, assuming that that's what happened.
Illanimi with a streak of 14 straight. We'll try a 31-yarder. And that streak is still alive. He has now tied the record for kicks, including consecutive seasons.
And there's a fan with a ball. He gets to keep that.
15 in a row for Kirk Illanimi. Finally gets a scholarship next season, and he's tied the school record. That guy got a nice souvenir, and yep. It's 24-13.
I believe I'd find a scholarship for that guy.
I would say so. They call that first one of the first half officially a 50-yarder, so that matched his longest ever. And Oregon State gets points, but just sends a real letdown feeling that they had to settle for that 3. From first and goal at the 7.
Yeah, but I guarantee you, Dennis Erickson is over there saying, hey, you got something out of it. You answered the bell, you've gone down by 14, now you came back and you put something on the board.
So
Corey Cott dropping back along with Dante Spencer. 36 seconds of the third quarter. Dominated by Pittsburgh. Cott's a hard time picking it up. Downed immediately. And the Panthers will start from their 18-yard line.
Ozzie got those things on his... Look at the... his eyes here. He's got one sideways.
Well, that's for glare. So you get...
Yeah, but up and down?
No, but
the lights are lower here, so the glare's coming in from the side.
I don't know. I think he's trying to do some kind of a fashion statement, and I don't think it's working. Uh-oh, there's...
Tyree! Drags Terrell Roberts to the 41-yard line. 23 yards for Myrie.
You've called this, Bill. You've called it all night, Bill.
They just keep hammering away, and oh, what a great job there by Dan LeCart, 52. Takes his man, drives him across the hole, and when Myrie sees that kind of opening, he explodes through it, dragging people, and he actually ripped away at the Virginia Tech game, ripped away from the defensive back, and went on and ran it into the end zone about 65 yards, and he darn near did it again. He's an impressive back.
That was the game winner at Blacksburg. This gives him 94 yards on 15 carries. Dominating that matchup at tailback with Steven Jackson. The number five running back in the country coming in. Myrie, Fitzgerald, Rutherford. Putting on a pretty good show for Pittsburgh as we reach the end of the third quarter and an 11-point Panther lead. Can they hang on to it as Capital One Bowl Week winds down here in the Bob in Phoenix, in the Insight Bowl. Fourth quarter coming.
Monday, presented by Bud Light, returns January 6th on ESPN.
America's top critics are united in their praise for Gangs of New York. Rolling Stone magazine raves it's the best picture of the year. And now it's been nominated for 5 Golden Globe Awards, including Best Picture of the Year. Gangs of New York, rated R. Now playing everywhere.
Has that cold settled in your nose and throat?
It's awful.
Then listen to AC's distractions and focus on your problem. That's what this new Alka-Seltzer Plus nose and throat does. It focuses on all these symptoms. Its concentrated medicine quickly dissolves and is ready to start working instantly, relieving your toughest nose and throat symptoms fast.
Thanks. I feel like myself again.
New Alka-Seltzer Plus nose and throat. And now Alka-Seltzer Plus is back in its classic seltzer flavor.
This is the Bowflex Power Pro. Quite possibly the most effective home fitness machine ever made. Bowflex is so effective that we guarantee you'll get the results you want in 6 weeks or less. You can own a Bowflex with no money down and payments as low as $33 per month. Call and ask for a free video and brochure, or visit us on the web today. Redefine your body.
I've always loved working on computers, and in the Army, that's what I do.
If you never thought about the U.S. Army or Army Reserve, think about this. There are 212 ways for you to become a soldier and work at a job you'll love. Call for this free video to find out which job is right for you. And if you call 1-800-645-ARMY right now, you'll also receive a free Army t-shirt with your video. Discover the 212 ways you can be an Army of One.
Tonight on SportsCenter, Banks will outplay Palmer. Fact or fiction? Boston's other green monster. Will the Mavs have it easy in New Orleans? And why is Shaq celebrating in December? SportsCenter after the game, ESPN.
A holiday feeling in the Valley of the Sun, Phoenix, Arizona. And the Insight Bowl reaches the fourth quarter, 24-13 Pittsburgh. 40,533, right about capacity for football in Bank One Ballpark. Pittsburgh by 11. They start in good shape. They're on 42-yard line. And Lusaka Polite gets his second carry. Gain of four, hit by Eric Tuma. The ESPN game track through three quarters. In this first ever meeting of the Panthers and Beavers, Fitzgerald got it started with that incredible dive from the five to the end zone, 40 yards. Robinson with the first ever punt return touchdown in a bowl game for the Panthers. 65 yards, this one would go. 50 yards farther than any return he'd had all year. And still the only Oregon State touchdown, the tainted 65-yard passing run, could have been ruled down to midfield to James Newton. Myree, back to that spin move, and no gain. Bill, you said in the first half you wouldn't want to teach a running back a spin move. Why not?
Don't teach them to spin with the football, because it's so likely that the ball is going to come away from the body, and as they spin, people put their head on the football and knock it loose. Now, this is an absolutely hopeless running play here, because there are nine men, count them, nine in the box. You can see one black hat after another one showing up there until finally Richard Sigler comes down with Myree, and as he spins, that ball could be knocked away.
Eric Tuma just had schooled Osaka Polite, the lead blocker,
yeah,
on that one.
Wow. They just decided they were going to run it no matter what the defense was.
It's a throw on third and six. Well, they wanted to. Rutherford feeling increasing heat as the second half winds on. Three defensive linemen, Manning, Edwards, Swancutt, all get a piece of Rod Rutherford.
Well, this is not like it's anything new for Pittsburgh. Coming into this game, they've given up 41 sacks. There's the stunt out and underneath. And then up the gut.
And a high snap handled by Andy Lee. But he bombs this one back to the 12-yard line, Eric Williams.
And what a great job by Torrey Cox.
Here's a flag. Here's two flags, Lee.
Now, I don't know who the flag's on, but Torrey Cox is really playing a great game as a coverer of punts. I did that for a living for a long time, although I did not run like Torrey did. I didn't have the decorations. Torrey, if you're going to cover punts like that, son, you can put that stuff on your face. It's all right with me.
Stands, this is the third punt tonight, a better than 50 yards for Lee. 52-yarder, another 52, and a 54.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct on the returning team. Half the distance to the goal line. First down.
They just answered it back. Gerald Hayes from Pittsburgh gave Oregon State one of those last time around, and now Oregon State returns the favor of stupidity.
Well, unsportsmanlike means somebody said something.
Yep.
It was probably not polite, no pun intended. Could not resist that. Inappropriate remark. And now they get to start at the five. You know how hard it is to drive from the five?
One-handed catch, Newsom. Breaks the tackle. It's 3 yards out.
Is he a great player? How did he catch that ball?
It got tipped,
look
too.
At that guy.
That ball got tipped.
Wow.
Got hit. The flight pattern is changed to the ball. He goes back for it, one-hands it, and then shakes the tackle just to boot.
Huge.
He had more than twice as many catches as any other Oregon State player. He had 64 coming in. Farley was second with 27. That's how heavily they rely on James Newsom in the passing game. He's had a big night, unlike Jackson, who is the running game. They swing it out to Jackson. That's one way to get the ball into his hand and a little room to work with, and he gets the first down.
And Jackson had 15 catches this year. He has nice hands as well. They'll split him out, and they'll go into an empty set with nobody in the backfield with him in the game, because they have such confidence. He had two touchdowns receiving this year. And they now have a first down. It's critical to get off that goal line and make the first down, so that if you do have to punt, at least your punter has room.
They've had 14 drives of 80 or more yards this year. So they can't extend the margin. Kittner
And another first down to the 30. Pretty good Oregon State running back. His own right is down with Dave Ryan.
Yeah, that's right, Dave. Ken Simonson here. 5,044 yards and 60 touchdowns at OSU, but you're not in the NFL. Now, you had a good run with the 49ers, a couple other teams. Where's your status right now in terms of pro ball?
Well, right now, I'm out here in Arizona just training twice a day and just working the phones and got a good team behind me that's really encouraging and trying to stay in shape and wait for something to happen.
I'm sure you've enjoyed watching the progress of Steven Jackson. How would you evaluate his play?
Man, he's one of the best running backs in the country right now, and he'll get the attention he deserves next year. I think it's kind of good. He didn't get too much limelight and hype, because next year he is going to be thrust into that limelight in a real big way.
And what do you want to say to Mike Golick up there? Last time you were on the field, Oregon State, Notre Dame, Fiesta Bowl?
Ain't no hard feelings, Mike. You know, I'm still somewhat of a Notre Dame fan.
Oh, I don't even want to hear it. They absolutely tattooed Notre Dame 41-9 a couple of years ago in the Fiesta Bowl, and just a fantastic performance by
them. Why did you have your head in your hands?
Because I was really hoping they weren't going to bring it up. Thanks, Rhino.
Anderson in trouble. Dropped at the 25. Vince Krochunas. Mike, sorry.
Oh,
we got this started. We got to carry it the whole way now. And pleasant memories for Jonathan Smith. All Oregon State fans, a night where everything went right up the road in Tempe. Open your eyes. Come on, watch it. Come on. Own your pain.
Are you guys showing a video right now? I really can't see anything.
And it's number 4 in the country, 11-1. Oh. That is the best bat I think any team's ever given a head coach. That was a direct hit. Clayson with the catch, first down of the 43. And Anderson seems maybe to finally have solved his wild high run.
Well, what Anderson needs, and Dennis Erickson knows this, so does the offensive coordinator, Tim Lapano, that he needs an offseason of just throwing. It's an accuracy thing. It's a footwork thing. He gets a little spread eagle. He doesn't really step through his throw every time, but he's got so much raw ability.
Hittner juggled, lost it.
And we've seen the long ball tonight.
There's Jim right there. Tim Lapano's worked at a lot of good places, including Purdue University, where he was a part of that Joe Tiller offense, and he understands what he wants to get done here, and Anderson's growing into this job.
Seems to change a little bit. We've seen the long ball, we've seen the overthrows, now we're seeing the short to mid-range passes, and Anderson has been on mark the last few.
This team for Lapano has actually outscored that 2000 team. Incomplete from behind Seth Trimmer. Tomorrow night, more NBA action on ESPN2. Beginning at 7:30 Eastern, the pregame NBA scoreboard, 8 Eastern. Ray Allen in Milwaukee, Jason Kidd in New Jersey. From the Meadowlands, NBA Friday on ESPN2. More, you can log on to ESPN.com.
That's what I wanted to bring up before to you, Dave. Mutombo deal going. I know he's out now with the wrist. You think that was a good deal for the Nets?
I tell you, with the success they had last year, I was shocked.
Yeah.
They were so quick to break that team up.
I was too.
From Van Horn to a rival. Anderson from the gun. Third and long underneath. Jackson dropped immediately. They are not letting him breathe. Lewis Moore immediately on him in midfield.
And another new defense, or new for Anderson to look at. A two-man rush, dropping 9 that time. So he had no choice but to throw the underneath route and hope that Jackson could break a tackle and make the first down. And that was not to be in this case. But they did drive the ball off the goal line.
And they're going for it. 4th and 5 from the 49.
I think this is a mistake.
I agree. A second time with you tonight, though, I agree.
Flag is down. Clayson with the first down catch in front of Spencer if it stands.
Well,
and it's not procedure penalty.
I don't think they're going to go for it now. I would be shocked. I was shocked they did it there, Bill. I agree with you. Now they'll move it back 5. I really believe they have to punt this thing.
Well, I do too. And Dennis Erickson.
Illegal formation. Offense. 5 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
Has a reason. Dennis Erickson has a reason for everything he does. So he had a play there that he felt like had an excellent chance of working, and it did.
Yep.
But they made a formation mistake, which is just unthinkable in a situation like this, and it looks like they're going to try for it again, and I think that's really, really a poor choice.
I agree. Let's keep an eye on Newsom. I don't even think he's in the game.
Wow,
this
is a two-score game, and this is not the time to be going for it on fourth down.
They go two wide, and Anderson has to throw up a prayer. No chance. Never had a prayer.
Well, Newsom has to be nicked up or something, because I can't even believe he wouldn't be on the field. There had to be some situation there why he wasn't.
Well, Brian Beinecke, number 15, got some pressure. He doesn't get much attention because he's out there with Gerald Hayes and Lewis Moore. Did a great job there.
Beavers decide not to play for field position. They decide to go for a fourth and 10. Didn't get it. Still down 11.
This is Gladys. Gladys works for a big computer reseller. When she's done selling, this is what you're left with. Jennifer works at Insight. She helps you find the products you need at prices you like from an inventory of over 100,000 products. Experts like Jeff, Ann, and Jim design, configure, and deliver even the most complex IT solutions. From a single notebook to enterprise networks, Insight delivers more products, expertise, and value, even financing options that extend your purchasing power. Insight, whatever it takes.
Okay, guys, get this bird put away, and we're done for the day.
With a new available Power Stroke diesel, 5-speed automatic torque shift transmission, and the most torque and horsepower of any diesel pickup, F-Series Super Duty goes way beyond just getting the job done. F-Series, the best-selling truck on the planet, is built for tough.
There's no reason why that ball should have gone through Buckner's leg. There's no reason why any of the runs before that should have been scored. There's no reason why the Mets should have even been in the World Series. No reason why they should have won 108 games. They were outmanned by the Red Sox. The Red Sox are the most dominating players in baseball. The numbers had almost become sublime. There are numbers that are actually bigger than baseball. Laws of probability that supersede the rules of statistics. Things that are even bigger than the curse of the Bambino. Things that say that if you call heads 100 times in 100 seasons, that one of those times is going to have to land heads.
Well, see, it's cold, and most of your heat is escaped through your head, so it's important to wear a hat in conditions like this.
That's also a good way to store your popcorn.
Look at this guy. This is true. We saw this guy, Bill, down on the field before. He had, like, the tight blue velvet pants.
That's the same kind of pants you wear.
Oh, I was just going to say, I thought you'd look good in those.
Panthers up 11, just off the fourth down.
Go to Myrie.
And a gain of 3.
So, Bill, what's going through Dennis Erickson's mind when you're going? Obviously, it's two scores down, but there was over 9 minutes to go when that went on, and we both think that was the wrong move to make.
Well, all I can figure is that he feels like his defense must be getting tired, and he did not want to give the ball up, and it was worth taking that gamble to him to keep from having this happen. It's about to happen right now, I think, because they are grinding him down. They might put one up to Fitzgerald. I would, or they might just keep handing it to Myrie.
Rutherford on a roll, and then cuts it back. He'll lose one.
And that's a planned play. And I thought we'd actually see some more of that. With Rutherford rolling out, he also faked handoff and then would follow the back right up into the hole. He's run for over 400 yards this year. We haven't seen it much tonight. Dave, you touched on it, but the coaches feel he hasn't been running the ball as well, but his passing has certainly improved. But I thought we would see a little more of him running tonight.
No, he's protected the ball. They said he is spectacular when he protects the ball, which he has. They still do not have a turnover. And 412 yards, 5, now 6 touchdowns, counting one tonight, on the ground for Rutherford. Dangerous every single snap. It's Gerald motioning. 3rd and 9. Froman, wide open.
now. This is 31. Dave with more on Rod Rutherford.
Dave, you have to be impressed with the play of Rod Rutherford tonight. Something we have not seen from him all evening long is a lot of emotion on the field, even though he has increased his practice intensity. By nature, he's not an outspoken person. Coaches tell us they've really worked with Rod on that to be more vocal in the huddle. And he's been interacting with his teammates on the sideline a lot here tonight, but really that calming presence, I think, has had a better effect than a screamer that you see a lot of quarterbacks in college football.
A lot of schools recruited him something other than a quarterback. Walt Harris promised if he came to Pittsburgh, that's where he'd play. Had them kind of in a flash roll early, some goal line quarterback, some wide receiver. Polite carries for no gain, but the last couple of years, Harris has stuck to his promise. And their relationship can strike many moods.
Well, they went through a really hard time early this year when the fans were all over Rutherford. They wanted to put Palko in, the true freshman, highly recruited quarterback out of Imperial, Pennsylvania. And Walt just did exactly what a head coach ought to do. He backed his man. He said, look, Rutherford's the quarterback. There's no controversy. Just get off his back. And Rutherford earned his spurs as the season progressed.
And we're Pennsylvania Player of the Year. There's one over a late recruiting surge by Penn State. Here's another flag.
Boy. Well, while they're piling up, unpiling all that, I am really surprised we haven't seen squat out of Chris Wilson tonight. Great tight end that can just fly. I can't imagine with all this man coverage that you wouldn't get the ball in the hands of Chris Wilson, who can outrun Larry Fitzgerald.
One catch, 7 yards.
Yeah, just, and that was the first play of the game.
And I agree, too, because they opened the game. We said 5 wide receiver set. He was in there, but I count him as a wide receiver.
Yeah, he runs like a wide
first
receiver.
First foul. Grabs in the face pass, defense. 15 yards. Wow. Automatic first down.
Well, Oregon State gives up over 100 yards a game in penalties. And here we are again as they hand over a crucial 15 yards on down into their red zone area.
On that kick.
Not really looking for him tonight.
Nope, they're not. He's just a junior, another year, but I tell you what, the pros are going to be liking that in the West Coast offense type style, splitting out
faster than Larry Fitzgerald.
Boy.
They ran a 40, and he is pulling away from Fitzgerald at the end. Myrie! Undercut by Weathersby. He saves the touchdown at the 5. He's fast, and he can block, too.
Yeah, well, maybe that's his job tonight, Bill. If they're not going to throw it to him, you got to block. He's not overly large, 6'3", about 240. Hands on, nice turn. Nice turn at the end there. To all in, Jason Jean Baptiste.
Yeah, he just whipped 47, Baptiste. And actually, Oregon State's done a good job in the red zone defense, giving up only 23 scores out of 36 times down here for the opponent. That's pretty good, but...
Brandon Myrie, touchdown.
Now, I got to say this. I have a lot of respect for Dennis Erickson as a football coach, but that was a direct result of the attempt to make it on fourth down as the Oregon State fans begin to file out here. Giving them that field position was just wonderful for Pitt, and they just worked it down there and got him a touchdown out of it and probably put the game out of reach.
You guys having a little Virginia Tech deja vu? That running game kind of taking over for
all over
Pittsburgh?
Again.
Yeah.
Myrie has his 400-yard game of the year, 20th carry, 112 yards. And the touchdown, which should salt the inside bowl away from Pittsburgh. We've got him back for another year. Duel with the PAT just inside the left upright. Most Panthers will come back. Slade's a senior, Reeves the center is a senior, Anderson the right guard. Everybody else will return to try and build on what's headed toward a 9-win season.
This is how most computer products arrive at your business. And this is what's left after the box is unpacked. At Insight, account executives help you find the products you need at the best prices. Hundreds of certified technicians and engineers design, configure, test, and install your IT equipment. Whether you're buying for a home office or one of the Fortune 1000, you get the best combination of product, expertise, and price.
right down to financing options that extend your purchasing power.
Insight, whatever it takes.
Wherever you choose to travel in the totally redesigned 2003 Ford Expedition, and no matter how unfriendly the traffic gets, you'll be surrounded by the protection of dual front airbags, plus the only safety canopy system available in a full-size SUV. The totally redesigned 2003 Ford Expedition. It has no equal.
Another holiday on the credit card, huh?
Yeah, my balance is really piling up. I'll worry about that in January.
You could get a Capital One no hassle card.
Nah. Finito!
High interest charges running up your balance? Get the Capital One no hassle card for the nation's lowest long-term fixed rates, $0 fraud liability, and no telemarketing.
What's in your wallet?
Have you ever wanted to develop your artistic abilities? If so, you may already have the interest and desire needed to become a serious art student. To find out, simply call toll-free, and Art Instruction Schools will send you this enjoyable art test. Since 1914, we've helped thousands of aspiring artists become more skilled, more confident, and more creative in their art. Call today for your free art test. We'll help you become a better artist. Call 1-800-633-3400.
Looking like that one's going to fly home to Pittsburgh. Inside Bowl Trophy with 5 minutes and 38 seconds standing between them. And their ninth win of the year would be a first since 1982, the end of the Dan Marino era. Cannonese to the 25. And now Oregon State down 18 under 5.5 minutes. And they'll get to work trying to slice into this fourth quarter deficit when we come back to Phoenix.
Tonight on SportsCenter, Banks will outplay Palmer. Fact or fiction? Boston's other green monster. Will the Mavs have it easy in New Orleans? And why is Shaq celebrating in December? SportsCenter after the game, ESPN.
Basketball on ESPN. The Bluegrass Rivalry heats up again. Kentucky takes on Rick Pitino's Louisville squad. Thanks, Bobby Knight and Texas Tech face Minnesota. College hoops all day Saturday on ESPN and ESPN2.
New car fever. Log on or make the call now. 800-397-CREDIT.
I got the car I wanted and the payments I could afford.
Got the new car fever? We've got the cure. 24 hours a day. Log on and apply. Or make the call now. 1-800-397-CREDIT.
I made the call because I had a few blemishes on my credit history. But I was pre-approved before I even went down to the dealership.
Open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Log on and apply. Or make the call now. 1-800-397-CREDIT.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the 2002 Insight Bowl, presented by Insight. Only Insight delivers the best combination of computer products, services, and price. Insight, whatever it takes. And in part by Ford, the best-selling trucks are built Ford Tough. And by Capital One, who asks, what's in your wallet?
Boy, if we were all that enthusiastic about our job.
Dude took a dive at the end of this thing. Went head first.
Yeah. Oh, boy. He's resting comfortably in the infirmary now in the back of the stadium, having pulled both groins and destroyed his lower back.
Oh, he had to throw up.
Nothing like watching a well-conditioned athlete.
There he is. He made it. He's okay. He's okay, ladies and gentlemen.
Been excused.
Yeah.
Ewis made the catch for 15.
Oh, boy. Oh, no.
Flag, but no whistle, and Anderson stands and watches as that ball is finally recovered by Guzik at the 18. Anderson made no move to go after that loose ball.
He was looking to his left to make a call, and the snap went right over his
offense,
head.
The penalty is declined. Pittsburgh's ball, first out.
Matt Block snapped the ball when Anderson was looking the other way. He was looking off to his left. See him looking to his left, and there goes the ball. Almost hit him in the right hand.
Now that he sees it and doesn't make any move.
He's still confused.
That.
He's still not sure what happened. There's no excuse for any of it, but something Block heard something and then thought he had the freedom to snap the ball. Most gun snaps are not timed, and they are not done on a cadence, but rather at the center's discretion, and there was just a mistake. Is this Palco in the game? Yes, it is.
They get a lot of work handing the ball off.
Bruce Freshman,
Pennsylvania Player of the Year for a state championship team in Imperial, and Jawan Walker, another true freshman out of Erie, with just his fifth carry of the year. So Walt Harris getting a chance to empty his bench, get some of the future Panther stars, they hope, out there. Sports Center will follow. We'll have some post-game coverage. You want to switch over to ESPN News.
Another personal foul, I believe, against Oregon State. I believe he's going to call face mask. I didn't see the grab of the face mask.
Yeah, I think it was on the run.
After this goal, first down.
Jawan Walker, when he was tackled. This is a big win. Now, this is a very big game to Walt Harris. I'm sure it was to Erickson and his staff as well, but Walt said this is a big game. It's going to be a smash-mouth game, and these guys came in here ready to play, did a great job of stoning the running game with the outstanding back, Steven Jackson, who gained only 36 yards and 19 carries. Not even on the radar of his normal performance. And there's the guy that bashed him the most legally. Nice tackle by Gerald Hayes, who's at least our MVP up here, we think he is.
10 tackles, over 400 for his career.
Yep.
At least half of those tackles have been head-to-head with Jackson, who has 33 yards on 19 carries. Before tonight, his worst game this season was 56 yards against UNLV.
Well, he had 36 at one time. He lose three of those.
Averaged 138. Walker.
Our Capital One Bowl Week coverage continues on ESPN with three games tomorrow, beginning with the College Game Day Bowl special presented by Outback at noon Eastern. And then at one, we get cranking from Houston, Southern Miss, Oklahoma State from Reliant Stadium, the Houston Bowl, 4:30 Eastern from Shreveport. Eli Manning and Ole Miss, Nebraska trying to end on an up note in the Mainstay Independence Bowl, and then L. Roberson at number 6, Kansas State, will close out the triple header against Arizona State in the 25th annual Pacific Life Holiday Bowl from Qualcomm Stadium. Under the 4-minute mark, and Tim Murphy gets just his third carry of the year.
You know, Dave, you talked about earlier all the people coming back for this Pittsburgh team, especially on offense, just losing three, and both their leading scorers coming back. And both their leading scorers were true freshmen. Larry Fitzgerald led the team in scoring. David Abdul, place kicker, was second. And Fitzgerald, I talked to him at practice on Monday and said, are you serious about your quote? He said, I plan on playing all 4 years at Pittsburgh. He said, my parents wouldn't have it any other way. I said, you better watch what you say. The coaches may look for that in writing because, let me tell you, the scouts, the pro scouts are going to love this guy. And he certainly will continue to master his craft here with Pittsburgh, but he is a special, special talent.
Getting it out at the moment as Palco will keep and score.
Wow. It's a great thrill. A lot of backup players are out on that field. A lot of kids get to play who normally don't get to play much, if any. And Palco gets a chance to score a touchdown. His first touchdown in his college career. Got a little speed. Made a mistake. He thought he was going to hold that ball out and get it over the goal line, and he got greeted at that very instant.
Seth Lacy almost cost him that touchdown. This is
is now the highest scoring bowl game ever for Pittsburgh. They had 37 1980 Gator Bowl against South Carolina. Another easy win, 37-9. It's now 38-13 in Phoenix.
Don't go away, though. We're going to tell jokes so everybody will hang around.
Don't say that.
Oh, okay.
K-State's powerhouse offense looks to cool off the Sun Devils. Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl. ESPN.
With its new available Power Stroke diesel and five-speed automatic torque shift transmission that generates 560 pound-feet of torque and 325 horsepower, the Ford F-Series Super Duty pulls faster and easier than any other diesel pickup. Ford F-Series, the best-selling truck on the planet.
Well, guess that settles that.
Yep.
It's built Ford tough.
Looks like this intern's moving up.
Promotion?
Oh, yeah, I'm on the fast track. Corner office, parking space, I totally deserve it.
How do you figure?
Well, look what I've learned. Dell helps people build their perfect PC to make it easy to order, and they have award-winning 24/7 service and support. You'll probably be reporting to me. Check it out. This is to notify you that our latest promotional offer is a free CD burner when you buy a Dell PC.
That's great. A PC customized for you and free stuff.
So no parking spot.
Call or go online now and get a Dimension desktop for just $569. America's favorite PC includes everything you see here. Monitor, keyboard, mouse, and speakers. And right now, for a limited time, you'll get a free CD burner. Get great deals on notebooks, too. Dude, you're getting a Dell.
Oh, life on the fast track.
Your perfect PC is easy to buy, easy to own, easy as Dell.
This is a live look at a setup. You're watching Walt Harris being set up for the Gatorade bath. He thinks they all want to hug him because they love him so much. That's why they wanted to hug him. They were holding him.
He should know better than that, Bill. You're a coach. You guys don't love you that much.
You want everybody. You want the guys to love you so much. And they got Paul Rose.
Yes.
The defensive coordinator. Oh, they got Walt, too.
Plenty of Gatorade buckets to go around.
Paul Rose has done a great job with his defense, and he is highly respected. When it was thought that Auburn was going to steal him away last February and pay him,
Myrie.
Oh, I love you so much, coach.
Yeah.
For Calvin Carlisle, leaping and hopping over tacklers all the way to the 40. Here we go. Worth the price of admission.
Oh, no.
No headlong dive this time.
Well, let's listen again.
Boy, oh, boy.
This was better to look at, actually.
That's the way you're supposed to run a kickoff back, though.
You're not kidding.
You hit that wedge like you're shot out of a cannon.
Well, Adam Ruffenflew is going to wrap things up at quarterback for Oregon State. Sophomore from Fresno, California, playing his seventh game of the year. Dwight Wright on the carry, our Capital One players of the game. So a lot of ways for Pittsburgh, but Gerald Hayes as important as anybody defensively in taking Steven Jackson completely out of the game. 19 carries, 33 yards, easily his worst game of the year. Newsom, 10 catches, 165 yards, and a touchdown. Even if they call that touchdown correctly, he has 10 catches for 115 yards.
And let's not forget those big guys that kept the blockers off Gerald Hayes and the other linebackers, Duzik, Stevens, Fortunas, and Harry out there. Nice job of hitting those gaps. They made a lot of plays tonight, Mike. They got in the backfield and made some tackles.
Absolutely.
And also took up two blockers each at times so that the linebackers could get a clean shot on the running back.
A lot of times those guys are used more as beasts of burden to try and eat up those blocks so those linebackers could make the plays. But you're right. Nice stunning and gap shooting today. But tonight to get into the backfield. Doing it again.
Right.
Nope.
Running over a couple of tackles for 7 yards. Want to say welcome aboard to all the sailors and marines serving at the Naval Support Activity in
Gaeta, Italy, watching the Inside Bowl on AFM, the American Forces Network. Happy holidays.
Thrills me to death that those men and women over there could watch us and maybe get just a little sense of home and know how much we appreciate them.
Well, they certainly got, it was worthwhile for them early with those catches by Fitzgerald and then the
personal foul.
Oh, boy, another personal foul against Oregon State.
Second down.
And even though that the touchdown for Newsom should have been called back, it was an incredible athletic move, so it certainly came out of the gates quickly.
Bill, Dennis Erickson seems early in his career to have made a decision to live with penalties like that.
Yeah, I think the what he considers to be aggressive penalties are things that are not discouraged, at least not vigorously, not like a lot of other people.
Right, knocked straight backwards. And let's send it down to Dave Ryan.
Well, Dave, 2 years ago, Pittsburgh played in the first ever football game here at Bank One Ballpark. That night against Iowa State in what was then called the Insight.com Bowl. The roof was closed for most of the game, and more than 40,000 fans are in a relatively small building here. Got pretty steamy. The playing surface got very slick. So Walt Harris, the pit coach, all week long with anyone he could find in a gold jacket, goes for the Fiesta Insight Bowl committee, making sure the roof would be open tonight. It was closed just prior to kickoff, but then after the opening festivities and the fireworks, it was open. Went down from about 65 degrees inside to about the mid-40s, but it's been comfortable, and the footing, I'm sure Coach Harris is very happy about that. It's been very solid all night long.
I don't think anybody can have any kind of complaints about any of the conditions. This is, it's a really amazing how well they have made this baseball-only facility, and it was built transfer to football.
And I was living here when it was a baseball facility, and the Arizona Diamondbacks played here, and they had the pool out there. It was amazing what they've done here, and then turn it into the great football field.
So the Panthers get their second straight bowl win, first win in the state of Arizona since the 79 Fiesta, first 9-win season since Marino was a senior, and they'll finish ranked for the first time since 1989.
And let's look at the fundamental performance by Pitt tonight. Very few penalties, no turnovers, nice tackling. Even here at the end when they put the backups in, those kids are up there stepping up, making form tackles. That's the way they're coached. Good football coaching job by the staff at Pittsburgh. You got to be impressed.
Oh, boy.
Oh, they're going to get all the coaches. All these guys, that's a GA. They all deserve to get the bath. Very disappointed with their loss against West Virginia and Miami in their last two games. Could have very easily won both those games. And then to come out here and play so fundamentally sound. And another thing I didn't say, a great job in the kicking game.
Yep. Torrey Cox was fantastic.
Torrey Cox put on a clinic about how you cover kicks.
First meeting ever between Pittsburgh and Oregon State will go to the Panthers, and they will finish ranked. And 9-4, Oregon State finishing 8-5. The Panthers are the 2002 Insight Bowl champions. As they break open a 10-10 game at the half with a 14-3 third quarter and one it going away. Coming up next, SportsCenter, we'll have post-game interviews and comments on ESPN News. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. The summaries and stats of this game. Log on to ESPN.com, your home for college bowl games on the internet. For Mike Golick, Bill Curry, Dave Ryan, our entire ESPN crew, Dave Barnett, so long from Phoenix. SportsCenter is next with Carl Ravitch and John Anderson. Tonight from the Bob.